engineer.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're now tuned in to the Leak Podcast. Hold on, let me get my camera right. Maybe I gotta scoot over a little bit. This way? Yeah, let me scoot over this way. Let me just move my camera. Hold on real quick. Hold on, people. Hold on. We're gonna get to you real quick. Yeah, we live on this shit. I bet. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, you're now tuned in to the Leak Podcast, the hottest podcast on the internet. Thank you for tuning in. You could have been anywhere in the world, but you're here with us.
It is.
And we appreciate that. 1,000%. Real quick, before we get started, based upon past interviews, let me just get this disclaimer off, right? Everything said tonight is for entertainment purposes only. Hey, for the record.
Hey. That part.
Let me get that off.
Well, I'll be talking reckless or what?
Anything you say is
me?
Documented.
Yes. Yeah, shit. Who, me?
Shit, I'm an entertainer.
Obviously. No, I say, I do.
Oh, not yet.
Okay, yeah.
No, I just got to get it out. Say,
oh, he will, though.
Yeah.
This is for future and all people that walk through that door.
Yeah, we got to make sure. Yeah. And real quick, you know what I mean? Just so everybody knows in the room, anything said and done in this room is recorded and documented. So watch your fucking mouth. Right? Let's make sure we get the disclaimers out the room real quick. Do me a favor, everybody that's watching the chat, send a link out. Let's get these numbers up real quick. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe. Get involved with the content. If at any point in time you guys want to call in and talk to anybody in this room, the number is scrolling right here through the screen. 626-209-9402. Hit the hotline. You can take over the show. Talk to anybody, like I said, and then we'll address it accordingly. You feel me? It's going to be up tonight. Hopefully, we get some phone calls. It gets interesting, usually towards the middle or end, but we'll see if they're brave tonight.
Let's go.
Let's see how it goes down.
I want all the phone calls. I need all the phone calls. Everybody got to call in. Call in.
Hey, shout out to Crunch App in the motherfucking chat. We see you too, brother. Going crazy. I bet. Sheesh, I'm excited. Today was like a little roller coaster, brother. JR, what's up? Talk to me, bro. How you feeling? Oh, shit. Already. Told y'all already. Hold on.
By the way,
thought,
right
JR.
Already.
All right. Hey, you're on the Leak Podcast. Who we talking to?
Yeah, you talking to Kel. 5150 and all that. I'm talking
to you. Oh, they calling in quick.
Whoa.
They calling in quick.
Danging them.
Yeah, hey, on fire though.
Hey, go ahead. Talk to your people. You got everybody listening. Yeah, say what you got to say,
I'm proud of my niggas, man. They doing their shit, man. Just got off a world nationwide tour. We outside.
Yeah, that part, man.
Hey, real quick, before we let you go. You got everybody listening on the internet. What's your message to the internet, bro?
Yeah, man. Shout out, gang, man. I love y'all niggas. For sure. Keep going up.
Hey, what's your message to everybody listening, the internet?
Hey, man. Watch out. 5150 up next.
Yeah, that's
man,
it. He's that.
All right. Appreciate the phone call,
gang.
Brother.
Hey, you know he a real homie when all he can talk about is the gang. He he's like, I don't know what you said.
What y'all talking
about? Hey, shout out my
5150. 5150. Yeah, real shit. I fuck with the vibes already. That's kind of how it works. For everybody paying attention, this is what we're going to be on tonight. This is the vibe. We're going up tonight, all right? Back to JR. Talk to me, brother.
Man, it's been a long week. I got a long weekend ahead of me, man. So
Vegas?
Yeah, we got Vegas booked up.
Big Jerk?
Big Jerk this Saturday.
Big Jerk.
Hit the rope. The next week, I think, next week we got another show. Out here, it's Joe Moses and Wally getting together on April 5th. It's going to be a big show. Showcase a lot of different artists is going to be up there. Shout out to both my bros doing their shit. Like I said, April 5th, I believe. Or April 4th? April 5th. I believe it's April 5th. Yeah, it's Friday.
Follow the page.
Yeah, it's going to be a big show. So that's the following week. The week after that, we in AZ. So all my AZ people out there. Up in Scottsdale again. Shout out to my bros out there at 1111 and Pretty Please. Booked.
Shout out Boulay Kev.
Shout out to
Boulay. If you run 1111 out there.
Yes, sir.
Shout out to Boulay Kev.
Yeah, that's his club out there.
Hey, my battery's still not recharged from Rolling Loud, bro. I'm still.
Still for real. I think I'm finally recharged.
Yeah.
I think this weekend really helped me a lot. Like, we went out and then I took for a little bit how to recharge. What did you learn this weekend, JR?
Patience.
Patience?
Yeah.
Yeah. You know what I learned?
What?
We have a crew. That's what I learned. That's what I figured out. I said, oh, shit. We got people with us now.
Let's talk about you, brother, real quick.
Go ahead.
Rolling Loud, right?
Yeah.
I seen a little incident that happened.
Yeah.
I ain't heard. I don't know what the fuck going on, but I want to know something. I want to know something. What happened? What happened with the incident?
What happened?
Well, bro, talking crazy. Who that? Dijon Paul? That's
the report card dude.
Yeah.
I mean, you saw we made the
live. We podcasters too. I gotta ask my podcast questions. Goddamn, I ain't playing.
Wait, hold on. Let me give
Since
you an intro.
Talking about
Let me give you an intro. Let me give you an intro. Then we run into it real quick. Hey, for everybody paying attention right now. Without further ado, help me give a big hand for Diamond Doe in the motherfucking building. Let's do that first. Before we get into the bullshit.
Appreciate it. I'm trying to get right to it, man.
Yeah.
Don't need no intro. They know what it is, man. 51 Mafia and all that, man. We the kings of the city, though. They ain't doing nationwide tours and they motherfucker like that. I swear to God, on God in heaven, I be running the track, running the streets, running the music. Come over to Orange County. We'll show you around. Come check in. You know what that is. 51 Mafia.
All that.
You know what I'm saying?
say that.
And I brought my peoples with me too, and all that. Shout out to all them, man. Snotty, Raps, Matt, all them. My brothers over
Shout
there.
Out
top.
The gang, man.
You know what I'm saying? I brought the shooters in here too. I brought my brothers with me. You know what I'm saying? But 51 Mafia, you know that. We in the building one time, man.
Say that real quick. We gonna take this shit over. All right, back to the bullshit.
Now we can get into it, right?
We had to just make sure. I wanted to make sure we give y'all proper intro and shit like
my
that.
My fault. Appreciate
it. But like, hey, you see, we did the report card, right?
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Now I know the report cards y'all doing. What's going on?
Hold on.
They calling in. What the fuck going on?
Hey, you on the League Podcast? Who we talking to?
Yeah.
Was it?
What the hell? Like that? They do that often.
It's the crazy part. They take time to look at the numbers scrolling. They dial every one of it, and they wait for it to ring, and then they hang up. That's wild as fuck. Wild as fuck. Anyways, so like, for me, I'm out here just cooking, you feel me, the podcast shit or whatever, and I put out a lot of content, and like, anybody that's popping, I said this before on the other podcast. You guys are just catching like wind of it now, but I had a whole rant, a whole episode ranting about what happened at Rolling Loud. But I'll give you the short version of shit.
For sure.
Basically, a lot of stuff that like out here that we talk about on the internet, we finally seen each other in person and online, from online, and he had security, so he got brave.
I hear that. What's up? It's report card beef. He didn't like that you did the report card.
He didn't like that we were talking about him coming out gay on No Jumper.
And he the one that announced that though.
No Jumper announced it.
Right, that's what I'm saying. They're the ones that announced it.
But it comes from a lot of like bottled up energy from the report card and other shit.
100%.
Blah 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 blah. Whatever. And so finally he had the opportunity. Yeah. And I'm like, yo, like for me, I see it like this. Anytime you're popping. Right?
Right.
You're going to be the topic of conversation. You're on the platform.
The number one rule I learned about podcasting is if you're going to say something, you better make sure you understand that they're going to react to it, right?
Yeah.
So you're going to get a reaction, right? And if you get reactions, that's a good thing, right? So it's like, you can't say something. Were they calling in? What's going on? Hold on.
Hey, you're on the League Podcast. Who we talking to?
Hey, come here. I'm from Big Bad Bobby Ryan and folks and homie.
Folks, gay.
Oh, shit.
Hey, I'm telling you, we got a shooter's call tonight.
Folks in the building, man.
Hey, they want you to say it one more time so everybody can hear you. Go ahead.
Y'all was crafty, homie. Vicious from Anaheim Falls. You already know in the game.
Hey, that's right, man.
Say that.
Gang members of this bitch, man. All right. We got it lit. That's right. Shout out to all the folks, man.
What did he say? He said, free me?
Free me soon.
He on the run.
Oh, shit. I'm like, nigga calling for the beat? It's crazy. That's really love.
On the set, man. I love my little homies, man. You already know. Folks up, man.
Hey, go ahead. What you got to say, bro? What's your question or comment? Go ahead.
I was on the run last music video, and then this music video, on the run again.
That's right.
We game banging
on this shit. All right. Chill. You gonna get me here? Chill out. Thank you for the phone call, brother. Oh shit.
Hey man, that's right.
Hey, he's hanging up on that. He's like, no more of that.
Yeah. They coming from my head already. We don't need any extra steam on this side.
That's right, yo.
Why? But I tell you, God, what I tell you.
Hey, the gang members in the building,
man.
A's up, though. You know what it is.
Yeah, for real. Hey, so, like, you guys weren't even at Rolling Loud. You guys were on the road. Where were you guys at during all that shit?
We was in, where was we at?
What was the last shit we went to?
Portland. Yeah, talking to Mike, though.
Portland. We was in Portland. Yeah.
You We was in Portland the whole time, goddamn. But that shit looked lit though.
Bro, that shit was active. For us, the tightest part for me, actually, going into Rolling Loud, it was my first festival I've ever been to in my life. And I told myself I would never go to a festival if I had to pay for it. Desto Dub hit me in the DM, said, I got a ticket for you, pull up, I need you to come do your thing.
Shout out Desto Dub. So love.
Hey, Desto Dub opened a big gate for us.
I love that. Shout out Desto.
And we went viral.
Desto one of those dudes. He showed love to everybody. I love.
That's
bro.
One thing I love about Desto Dub. He cool with everybody.
Oh, God in heaven.
Yeah, that shit hot. Yeah, for sure.
And if you not cool with Desto, it's like you probably the one that's not cool. You feel me? Like,
type shit.
I don't know.
I've seen him show a lot. I've never seen him like flip on anybody. I always see him go show love to everybody standing in line for his merch.
Yeah, 100%.
Giving dabs, love pictures, and all that. It's 100%. All love. Yeah.
Hey, shout out my brother Killswitch on that stage too, man. He shut Rolling Loud down and all that. 5150 member. You know what I'm saying? We was on a big stage. You know Killswitch?
Nah.
Puya.
Well, maybe we can hear some music.
Yeah, hell yeah. He going platinum. He going platinum with it. He just went gold.
You know who Killswitch is?
No.
We gotta hear him tonight.
Yeah, he make kind of like different music and all that. But he was on a big stage. On the left.
Yeah, well, that's the stage we were in front of the whole time. Was the main stage.
He was going crazy.
He had a
mosh pit going. It was...
He had a daytime. Went around what time was
daytime.
Yeah,
I was supposed to be out there, goddamn.
Sunday, got you.
Shit was lit, though. Yeah, Rolling Loud a little lit, though. A little fun.
Yeah, she was activated.
I'm only going if I'm in the back, though. I can't.
Yeah. That's what I was saying.
They be kicking up dusty.
I realized at Rolling Loud that I didn't like to be in the crowd. That's what I realized for sure.
Well, I'm never doing that shit again. Damn.
Phone got stolen. Everybody phone got stolen. I seen that TikTok.
My phone got took from my pocket. I don't understand. I was being escorted and some more shit. Like,
they really scoring out there. They really went just to steal phones.
It's crazy
because
like my boy right here, you know, he's always looking out for me.
Yeah.
He had just told me like take everything out your back pockets because they be taking shit.
Literally,
I'm like,
just
bet.
Talk to nigga.
So I put my wallet in my front pocket with my phone.
Oh my God. And they still
we
got
go
you.
Like, I say 100 steps, bro. Get to where we're going, we stop. I'm like, my phone gone, bro.
No way.
No. It was that fast. It's kind of like when you're walking through the crowd, it's like going into the ocean. It's like you're in the shallow and it gets deep and deeper and deeper. Once you just get embodied with everybody,
it's over.
Yeah, you get sucked into that
shit. I get a panic attack in that shit. Yeah, I can't do this shit.
So took my L next day to go buy a brand new 15 Pro Max, whatever the best one is. You feel me?
Yeah.
It's just mandatory.
I can't do that. 15, they got the new charger, you know that?
Yeah.
Hell yeah. That was mad about that.
I was about to get the 15. I'm not going to get the 14 because the 15 got the bullshit ass chargers.
At some point,
my phone's going to die and I'm not going to have my charger. No one's going to have that. Whatever that is.
USB-C.
USB-C.
It's literally the new wave, though. Like, all the new cars got it. You feel me? Like, and it charges like in 20 minutes. This motherfucker fully charged.
We having phone charger politics right now.
It's a speed charger.
I'm still on the old shit.
Oh shit,
man, let go.
Fuck with it. 714. Hey, what's up? What's going on? Who we talking to?
Hey, free my Baltimore folks. Free that poor grimy. Free bully.
Look at that. Hey, the homies. Hey, bro, you don't know, bro. The homies gonna call
for
in.
For the game, man.
That's it. You gotta let it be known.
Bullshit ass charger. Nah, I'm rolling. They fucking with the charges. I bet. Hey, so for everybody that hasn't been following your guys' journey real quick, tell everybody what you guys do and all that good stuff. Let's just break down like foundation for everybody that doesn't know who you guys are. Go ahead, though.
Yeah, man. If you don't know me, you know what I mean? Ask about me, man. Though, so official and all that. Straight from the juice and all that. I mean, shit, man. We just... Biggest shit coming out the door, straight up.
No, for real. We just come from Anaheim. We just, you know,
up, like,
came from this.
Hey, question. The Two Tone Twins come from the juice too, right?
Yeah, they do. What city they come from? Tustin. Yeah. Oh, they from Tustin. Is Tustin OC? Yeah, that's OC, right? Yeah, that's OC.
You fuck with them?
Yeah. Shout out to Two Tone Twins, man. What the hell? Yeah, for shit. So
y'all the biggest. They popping noise. I need to make sure y'all both checking in with each other, but both of y'all know about each other.
Shout out to Two Tone Twins. I got mad love for them. They're my sisters for real.
Yeah,
but we the biggest in the juice. Shout out to my sisters, though. Yeah. On my mama's life.
Hey, they know what's up, though. You know what I mean?
And when I talk about the biggest in the juice, I mean the juice. They might be popping elsewhere. You know what I'm saying? But when we go to them Anaheim streets, when we go to Santa Ana, when you're going to, you know, Buena Park, Stanton, Fullerton, you know what I'm talking about? The north side, like, you're not hearing nothing but 5150. And then... That ain't no diss, because my sister's viral. You know, Two-Tone Twins viral, but I got to let it be known, because when we step in this building, I don't come for no other reason but to tell you that we the one doing that shit for real.
And the OC, man, we run that shit.
You know what's
crazy? I take pride in that. That's the only thing I take pride in.
And for me, like, I pay attention to what's going on out there in the climate and stuff like that. And I felt like for a long time, the OC was, like, vacant. It was, like, open for the taking, right?
Oh, we took that motherfucker.
No, there wasn't, like there wasn't a lot of noise. Everybody was focused on L.A., and then it was, like, second was the IE, but nobody was really saying shit about
Diddy, no
OC,
Diddy.
Yeah. And then I seen y'all, and I was like, yeah, they got it.
I get it.
But it's one thing to say it, and then it's one thing to actually see it.
100%.
Right? It's another thing to see it, because, like, a lot of people say something, but I feel like we've known each other long enough for 100%. Me to pay attention and actually watch what's going on. So I wouldn't
say. I can say you could be a witness. You know what I'm saying?
Witness.
You've only seen like a year of the journey, but imagine if you watching 6, 7, 8 years of this shit. You know what I'm saying? Like
type shit.
I started when I was 18. You know what I'm saying? I'm 24 and I feel like I'm getting
old.
People
been tapped in for a minute. I mean,
it's been a thing. You know what I'm saying? But now it's at a tight.
Yeah, but watching from the outside, I fuck with it.
I appreciate that, and I fuck with this shit. Y'all working in this motherfucker for real. I love it.
Yeah, this shit wasn't built overnight. I mean, we've been doing this shit for a minute and shit. I mean, we've been grinding and shit, but right now, like. Ew, I mean, we just on top right now. You feel me? We good.
I bet. Hey, let's dive into the interview real quick. Yeah. Doe, last time we had 5150 here, the whole squad, the gang, everybody. You wasn't here. Break down for everybody where you were, where you was, all that good shit. Go ahead.
Man, at that point in my time, I was on ankle monitor. I was like,
couldn't
fighting
leave
my
the house.
Case and shit. You know what I mean? So,
talking about
like, I couldn't really move around how I wanted to, you know what I mean? But shit, I already went, took care of what I had to take care of, did my little shit, you feel me? Now I'm back, you know what I mean? And we busting shit, you know what I mean?
Crazy, yeah. Shout out to you being home, brother. Welcome back.
Appreciate that.
Hey, let me ask you this. Being outside, having your freedom, and then knowing you had to go back in, and knowing, like, okay, there's a clock on it and shit like this, how much do I got to set up myself for being able to let my shit still spin out there, but then I still got to tuck for this amount of time. Talk to me about the mental real quick. Like, how did you prepare yourself for that, and where are you at today? Real quick, before we move on with the interview.
Shit, honestly, I didn't really know how it was going to go, you know what I mean? Because I was fighting some time and shit, you know what I mean? But luckily,
what were you fighting?
I was fighting, it was trying to give me, the last deal they offered me was 7 years.
Talking
you know
about
me? The last deal they offered was 7 years. I was supposed to. They was trying to force me to sign that shit, but nah, I was like, nah, fuck that. We don't go to trial. I mean, but I
got going to trial, the scariest thing,
yeah,
too.
We went up to the next courtroom. That judge offered me 32 months, signed that shit, you know what I mean? And I had already did a year before I bailed out. I was out on $1 million bail, you know what I mean?
Time served and all
so,
that.
So I was already down a year, so I only had to do like another 6 months. So I just went up state real quick. I mean, did my little shit. But, you know what I mean?
I guess my question is, when you're in that courtroom and you're going through these emotions, just real quick, what's going through your head at that point in time? Because that's out here, what you put out is like Instagram, the cool shit, it's all that. Yeah. But when it gets real and you're really behind that table, what emotions are you feeling? Walk us through it real quick.
Shit, man, I'm just trying to, keep my head up, you know what I mean, and keep shit moving type shit, you feel me? I already know what I mean. Like, we all got to go through some shit, you feel me? So I was just happy with what I got type shit.
Say that.
And I seen bro in that courtroom just straight up, head up, worried about what's in front of him. That's all you can do, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I mean, it sucks. I mean, I got my daughter out here. I got my kids out here type shit. So it's like, I mean, it's fucked up. But, you know what I mean, as a man, I mean, you got to stand on what you stand on type shit. So I knocked that shit out.
Yeah. Shout out you, bro. For real.
And I told bro, this the last time, because Diamond Doe Show not ever going to stop.
Hey, man.
This shit. This the last time, bro, going
hey,
to jail.
Hey, but I came home straight on tour, you know what I mean?
Straight on tour, though.
Right
put them right
to
on
the
tour.
Bag and shit.
Come on.
We out here running it up, for real, though.
Hey, the crazy part is me and Dom had conversations, and I told him this. I said, bro, like, I understand, like, it's a Diamond Doe Show, so, like, I understood the podcast was going to take a hit. And I said, whatever you need to help you keep busy and all that,
stay in the loop
so we could just keep going, because it's like a matter of time to stretch it out. And the crazy part is, I seen Dom just pick that ball up and run that shit to the fucking end zone. That shit was fucking crazy. Right? That's when Four got involved. Oh, yeah, a lot of shit changed.
I'm like, we got to step it up, though. Because bro going to be gone, so that's my other half. You know what I'm saying? Like,
say that.
Like, I gotta go 120% now. You know what I'm saying? Like,
hey, Dom, when Doe left, that's when I seen your greatness.
Yeah, hell yeah.
In the beginning, I seen the cool version of you.
100%.
You feel me? Because we're in the room and we're talking shit. Yeah, 100%. Hold on. Hey, on the League Podcast, who we talking to?
Yeah. Yo, the Top Collectors, baby, from East Coast.
Whoa, Bridgeport, Connecticut in the motherfucking building. What up? Yeah. My people from Bridgeport.
Hello, what's going on, baby?
What up?
Chillin', what's up? Talk to me, brothers.
Chillin', man. You're here with Rob and Rick, man. We just want to show love, man. Encourage you guys, man. You guys are doing your thing. You guys always in the motivation for us as well, man.
Appreciate it.
Say that. Yeah. Appreciate the phone call. Yeah. Hey, real quick. You got the internet watching, listening, all that good stuff. What's your message to everybody else, bro?
Hey, yo, you just gotta let people need to know that if you you look good, you smell good, then you feel good, baby. That's all you gotta
do. Say that.
Then you is good.
Hey, no cap. I fuck with you guys. Miss you guys, bro. Hope we see you guys soon and shit. For real.
Hey, we want to go out there, man. I was talking to Rick, man, for the when you guys hit 10,000, bro. We invited to the party or what?
The 10K party, pull the fuck up.
10K party.
Whoa. Hey, if y'all pull up to the 10K party, that'll be kind of lit. I haven't seen them in a decade.
That's right.
Yeah, crazy.
Hey, no, we root for you guys, man. You guys are motivation all day, man. Love, man. Hope everything's all good, baby.
Thank you, brother. Appreciate the phone call.
No problem, man. Take care, brother.
Say that. Bridgeport, Connecticut in the fucking building. My people. Say that. Yeah, good luck.
Love.
Back to it. Like, for me, I really seen, like, your greatness when it counted. You feel me? Because what we say here in the pod is, it's ha-ha until it's nah-nah. Right? It's all fun and games and all that shit is cool until it gets real. You feel me? And, like, for some people, the reality hits, like, unexpectedly. And then for you guys had time to prepare for it.
Oh, yeah, preparation.
Preparation. Yeah,
talking about performance. Yeah. Oh, my God, I'm mumbling, but yeah, you heard what I'm saying.
But, yeah. But the preparation part.
I tried to say some shit, but
yeah.
You heard me, the 5 P's, though. But, like, nah, for real, though, like, you know, that's all it was, though, like, just making sure, like, when he come back, it's going to be good, it's going to be viral still, you know what I'm saying? It's going to be straight, like, that was the main goal, main focus, you know?
Crazy. We've been having a couple conversations in this room, and a couple of the questions that came up is like, what artists can really like travel on tour right now outside of LA?
Not a lot of them. And my big brother Ford could do all that though, nationwide and all that. 5150 Mafia, yours truly, man. Shout out, we in the building,
part, man.
I'm talking about like, we doing superstar shit, bro. And anybody in the city trying to compete, it's like, do some superstar shit, and then we could be in competition. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. That goes to anybody that.
Hey, we make this shit look easy, bro. But
this
really
shit ain't easy,
man,
though. I dedicate my life to this shit. Twin, blood, sweat, and tears. Am I lying? Nah, I put my life on the line for this shit. So anybody that want to compete with me, you better be at that same power. I don't even want to compete with nobody. Because if you're not even there,
no
I would know if you was there.
It ain't no competition, like, bro. Yeah, we like not in the juice. Yeah, we straight up. Like,
we popping that shit for real because we really do this shit.
I feel like when it's all fun and games, it's competition. But when you actually go through that real shit, it's like, I don't even got time to look
left
or right.
We're going through real life
push-ups.
Shit.
Exactly. I'm breathing and I'm doing push-ups.
He rappers pussy.
I'm in the field. Fuck that shit. No, really, me. Pussy. That's how, you feel me, type shit. And then the other thing is, it's like, yeah, it's one thing to like say, okay, we booked a tour and we're traveling and going to all these little spots. But everywhere you guys went.
I showed them every show, good or bad. Yes or no, didn't I?
Yeah,
I put every show
on
my Instagram, good or
yeah,
bad.
Yeah. But I don't recall, you know, to my recollection, seeing a show that was bad. Like,
bad, but, you know, small. If there was 50 people in there, if there was 1,500 people in there, I put it on Instagram for them to see. You know what I'm saying? Because
I seen panties getting thrown on
stage.
No,
for sure.
That's what I seen. I didn't see little shit. I seen big shit. Hey, maybe I missed that day.
Hey, dumb.
The panties was on stage. She was waiting for months to do that. I swear to God, like we really popping.
Did you find out who it was?
Yeah. I already kind of knew who it was because she DM'd me on Instagram. She like, I'm in the crowd. I'm gonna throw my panties on. So I was already kind of expecting it. You know what I'm saying? So I go, I went on stage.
So she found out.
She threw it at the perfect time. I swear to God, I was in the middle of my best song. Right before the best part, she threw the panties. I was like, whoa.
Hey, but wait, yeah, wait. So then she just had it in her pocket. She didn't take them off.
Yeah, I was just finna say that.
This
I was
is
just
the difference.
Say
if
that.
She came prepared for it.
Hey, that's what we were talking about. That's what we were talking about. We were talking about this.
Hold on.
I'd rather than be on that stage clean than her throwing some used panties up there. Cause I touched them bitches. Touched them shit. I like my man.
No, we hanging up. We don't answer unknown calls. Fuck that.
They said, Dom, did you smell them eyes? For sure did not smell them. I got a video proof. Go on my Instagram. I got a video of that shit. I ain't smell nothing. I picked them up real quick.
Was there yeah, so like you guys just left them on stage. Did you take them with you? Want some
hell
drink
nah,
shit?
I put them back on the stage. I'm like, hell. Fuck out. What the hell? What I'm gonna do with some panties though?
Add them to the collection for the tour.
Nah, I don't wanna collect.
Hey, I got a wrist. I got. See this whole shit? This is called memorabilia. Yeah, collect it.
Them look nice. Some little panties, they ain't nothing.
Hey, listen, hey, we got pussy in a can. We collect shit.
I like
over
it.
Here.
What that right there? That's that shit. Pussy?
Yeah, pussy juice.
Ah, that hard.
Pussy juice.
Yeah. I ain't eating no pussy. I probably cannot drink that.
I don't know if I want to try that.
I don't know about that.
No.
I ain't ate pussy since I like 18.
Not doing it.
Say that. All right, hey. You good?
Yeah. I swear to God.
Jared, what's up? What are you thinking over there, brother?
Nah, he just, I was laughing at the talking comment he just made.
Like, which one?
I didn't eat no pussy since I was 18.
Hey, hold on. Hey, what made you eat pussy at 18? In your head, what were you thinking?
You gotta try, look, in life, you gotta try everything one time, right? So, you gotta try that shit, but nah, that's not for me, though. No, y'all, hey, y'all lying. No, y'all ain't never ain't no pussy. Y'all all lying. Everybody in that room is lying. If you
hey,
y'all,
the League Podcast, who we talking to?
It's DJ Catnip from Fullerton, man.
Whoa, what up, brother?
Yeah.
Hey,
I heard the panties was bigger than dough.
What did he say?
I heard the panties were bigger than dough.
I heard the panties thrown on stage was bigger than dough, so official. They covered him.
He tried. You a bad comedian.
Yeah.
If you was at a comedy show,
is that what we're doing? All right, bet. Hey, hang up on this.
No. Let him talk.
Pull the trigger. Let me know. We good.
Hey, you got to come with something.
Hold on. We're going to let him cook.
Let him cook.
All right, hold on. Hey, you got one more try. Go ahead. We're listening, brother.
Yeah, come on.
He said the panties was bigger than Dos Office.
Hey, the crazy part is that before he called, he's like, this is what we're going to say. This is what we're going to say.
We're going to
Hey, I'm hold a short on. Nigga, too. I ain't even that big, man.
Hey, y'all got the smoke looking crazy in this fucking room. Hey, you're on the League Podcast. Who we talking to? Can you open that door for me just to let them out?
Hey, yo, Big Swag OD, the one and only Macaroni. No, frozen.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Hey, you know what time it is, man. I had to call in and tap in with my guys. What's happening?
What's hey, the word?
Yeah, what's Final. The deal,
man? Hey. Go ahead, brother.
No, I just want to say what's happening with my peoples, man. I should be there, man. But, hey, I tell you what. All that, Dom probably ate pussy last night. I tell you what, Paul.
That nigga Snotty
ain't said shit the whole time. Oh, you know he was eating pussy.
Go ahead.
Hey, but look though, man. Hey, look. Shout out to the homies, man. It's Big Swag OD from the OC, the one and only Macaroni, no phony. I tell you what, man.
OC and this bitch for real though.
He did the little laugh with it too. It's crazy.
He a real vet though.
Hey, you know what time it is.
Hey, appreciate the phone call, brother.
You already know. Hey, y'all go up, man. Matter of fact, fuck with me at OC 11, man. Strip club, gentlemen's club in Orange County, man. We going up.
Free promo.
That part, man. We popping out.
Hey, you got me at the door?
I got you at the door, my nigga. DJ C-Rock on the ones and twos.
Okay.
You know what time it is.
Hey, we inside.
We're there.
Say that.
100.
All right, good. Hey, thanks, brother.
One.
All right,
yes, Sersky.
All right, what were we talking about again?
I don't even fucking know.
Eating pussy and shit?
Yeah, I guess.
The big penny hose.
Oh, the big penny hose?
Hey, what's the max capacity, matter of fact?
You said what?
What's the max capacity?
Where?
On a girl. Like, what's the, like, the biggest?
Talking to Mike.
Like the biggest, girl? Yeah, what's the biggest you going for? Like 200, 300?
Oh, I'm not going for nothing even chubby. No, not even a little chubby. I swear to God.
So what's the max capacity? Like 180, 200?
And like chubby for me is like, I don't know. Depends on the
For you, what's max capacity?
180 is good.
What, 80?
Is that big? I don't know, because I'm 220, so I don't know what. I don't know what big. That's big.
Hey, now me, hey,
back there. Hey, that BBL gonna have to, you know, weigh about 60 pounds.
Hey,
60 pounds?
We need that big ass BBL. Bow.
No, but wait, hold on. You fuck with like fake ass and titties, or you like real?
I like both. I like women.
No, but you gotta choose.
Shout out to women.
No, but you gotta choose.
I don't know. Shout out to women.
No. You gotta choose.
Tall, small. I just don't like fat bitches.
Huh?
I don't like fat bitches, but some of the homies do.
Oh, shit. I ain't gonna tell. I like some thick bitches too.
Hey.
Oh, bro.
Hey.
When they think in the right places, but he said the wrong thing. He said fat.
That's
the motherfucking time, Ray. Y'all got me fucked up in here.
Hold on. Hey, is that like something you're into? Like you fuck with big girls?
No, don't talk.
I don't know what this nigga talking about. I like thick women though.
Yeah, but what's the
dribble?
Yeah. So, so like the biggest girl that you took down was twice your size or once your size?
I say she about twice
three,
my size.
3 years? He said three.
He don't know nothing. Nathaniel.
Hey, the fact that he know what you taking down is crazy.
I don't take down the Thor thighs, my boy. I'ma tell you that.
He like the Thor thighs.
But I will take down Sean Thick.
He done took down the grenades before for shit. So.
And so has he. So
that's his rap. We got homies here. Real homies.
I ain't hearing it. I ain't hearing none of that.
Fuck that, he lying.
Show the big girls love. Show the big girls. That's what they're saying in this chat. I bet. Ain't nothing wrong with big girls, though.
Hell no.
You know why? Because it gets cold. And the little ones look cute, but they start shriveling when it's cold, and it look like they need to eat. On God in heaven. It look good on camera. For the gram and shit. Look good on the gram. But when you see them outside, toes is fucked up.
That's the worst thing.
Low the catfish.
Yeah, the low
iron. You know what you gotta do?
The low iron ones that like bruise easy. Oh shit! Hey. They just got like dark spots on their arm and leg and shit. You're like, fuck. Yeah.
What you gotta do? You gotta go to the bitch Instagram.
You are now tuned.
You gotta go to the worst picture she got on Instagram, and that's what she look like in real life. That's the rule.
You know
what I'm saying?
I'm a firm believer.
Right, though? You gotta go to the worst picture.
Yeah.
Like, what do you really look like?
Fuck that. Fuck the Instagram. You gotta go to the Facebook.
I'm a firm believer. I don't know I love you until I see what ugly looks like. Yeah. I need to see the ugliest version of you to
exactly.
see if I fuck
exactly.
with you.
Exactly. That's what I'm trying to say.
Oh, God. Everybody has an ugly point.
Oh, God.
Even the prettiest bitch alive.
I'm pretty.
You seen Kim Kardashian cry?
No Diddy. So said
No Diddy.
Hey. Hey, somebody just trademarked that shit.
I know, yeah.
Bro, somebody went to like and did paperwork. For the No Diddy. Like what do you get because everybody says
Oh, the dude from Philly.
Yeah.
Forgot his name.
Like what do you get for that because like you trademarked it? I don't understand it.
Well, I mean like it's gonna be a joke now. Like No Diddy.
He might
get
paid.
Yeah, but why would you trademark it though instead of just letting it live in the universe? You feel me? Like
well, so you think Diddy guilty?
If he running, so
he running.
You think Diddy guilty, yes or no?
Like, come on.
Yes.
He guilty?
Hey, the reason no. I don't know details. I don't know details, but if I had to choose, I would say yes. Only because I'm watching on TV, like, all the breakdowns and the internet, and everybody's putting the whole storyline together with Clyde Davis and Usher and Justin Bieber and like a lot of this other shit. It just looks, it's just like, it doesn't look good,
highly
bro.
Suspicious.
Yeah. We can say no and try to defend it, but at the end of the day, it's like when you have a lot of money, you don't know what you would do until you're in that position, bro. And you're just powerful, bro. Like even to the like Pac and Biggie shit, like you feel me? Yeah. It gets real as fuck.
Yeah. He didn't pay his Illuminati fee. That's what happened. They canceled his ass, bro. They canceled
crazy. But I was saying this too, though, like with the legends, right, in our time, right, everybody looked at Diddy like a legend. But the only thing that's fucking these legends up is time. Time.
Yeah.
And the solid ones remain, and the fucked up ones, the legacy has like a end date. You feel me? Yeah. It only covers so long until that shit starts coming out. And then it's just like, yeah, I feel like Cassie was the first to really open that shit up. Like,
she did.
Had to be a woman.
That's fucked up. With the
well, no offense, ladies. You feel me?
Kind of what happens.
Yeah. Huh?
So it's kind of just how it
it's
works.
It's kind of how it happens. Yeah. Fire. I bet. Real quick, where are you guys at right now? Motion-wise, you guys are off tour and shit like that. Yeah. What do you guys got going in like for you guys musically right now that tour's over and all that?
I'm about to drop the TRX music video and all that. You know what I'm saying? The hottest shit in Orange County. But honestly, though, Doja did a video, and he about to take over too. So we both probably going to drop videos at the same time right off a tour. You know what I'm saying? With both of us, bow.
Yep. Okay, so from the outside looking in, you guys ain't a group. You guys are individual artists, but just fuck with each other under
it's
the same umbrella of the 51.
It's just a
5150 is the same umbrella. I bet. Hey, Jay, are you loaded up with music over there?
I got two tracks. Yeah, I got some.
You got one from each? You sent him is one and one?
I think I sent him two. I think I sent him two. Yeah.
Doe, can he get one? What?
I sent him one from him, one from me.
What he got is one and one?
Yeah. Hell yeah. Oh, that's what she was asking.
Yeah, we going to play the music
now. We did one song together.
Okay.
Yeah, that's cool, but we need more than one and one. Y'all trying to rock out tonight, right?
While they playing there, I'm gonna send some more right now.
Say that. All right, cool. Hey, face the camera. Tell us what we're about to hear real quick. Hey, Jerry, you can mix both those records together?
Yeah.
Let's do it. I don't even remember what I sent him, goddamn. It's just some unreleased and some released shit. You know what I'm saying?
Say that. Let's go crazy. JR, run that shit up.
Oh, I said it. Hey, we going crazy.
Hellcat, I'll put a kid on me. I'll make him come up by your watch. I'll put my wrist on it. Whatever street sell pussy, I'll put my bitch on it. Me and Twink got matching APs. How ironic. Got your body tag on. She was on Drake shit. I don't want a pretty nice girl. I need a mean bitch. She want a rapper with some motion. That's me, bitch. Dog shit. All up in your face. 3D shit. I don't want to hold it. Hand it over. Make me rich. I'll fuck you up in the club. Take keep shit.
Take keep. Fuck these niggas.
Lame man. With the most money, other side, they gon' always hide. They don't do nothing. You in the whip, pull a stick, tell them show some. I be on the north side, fine and got two guns. Youngest rapper in my city with the most money, other side, they gon' always hide. They don't do nothing. You in the whip, pull a stick, tell them show some. I be on the north side, fine and got two guns.
Son, where'd you find this?
I'm scamming with the bros. I ain't about this hoe. Feel about to swipe a wipe your nose. About to trip by that hoe. Try to tell him let it go. I ain't fucked it on the side. I ain't find a way to go. All this money on the floor and all that smoke up in the air. Suckers waving white flags. Man dying now they scared. And the trace never there. We on the alley never here. They never did. One smoke on G's. We never care. I ain't fuck that red beef. I got some money now. Like, yeah, monkey nuts and chop out 100 rounds. Yeah, we eat real good like a thick bitch. And I'll break your ass down like a brick bitch. Call me John. Talking about the shooters, guarantee he ain't hit shit. Really, you a loser, I ain't never seen you win shit. Spin up on your block, fuck around and hit a kick. Too much rapping, too much talking, trying to get going. How we king of my city, he ain't hit a motion. Plug, come on, oh. Turn the rain to balls in. Plug, come on, fall, trying to get the load in. You bitch on the chair, I was 12, I ain't talking about that face. You saying it, you waste. Yeah, I wanna get that nose in. Sell it like it's quit. Really got some motion, I'm living with our bitch. Find a hug to the hills, but still connected on the blocks. Love a bitch out the bottom, cause they love to get top. Got my game from the OG, soaked it up like a mock. Had to cut some niggas off, Photoshop, they got pride. Fuck an Instagram beef, I have a folks on your block. Real killers moving silence, Johnny's know I don't talk. If you're a homie from the hood, then light it up, we can buy. But if you ain't from my gang, nigga, I'll put you in a box.
Five, you know what it is, man, Diamond. Goni, motherfucker, man. G-O-D. Anaheim's finest, man. And we run the city. Bitch. Pussy.
Hold on. Jagged DKI. Get the fuck out of the chat if you ain't fucking with me. With the burner account and all that shit.
I got more money than you, bitch.
Hey. On this side.
Tell him.
Hey, on this side, everybody look at you when you talk out loud in that comment section like, oh, what? Hold on. Get the fuck out of here. Hey, good energy only type shit. You feel me? It's good up. Anybody on that negative shit, we out. I'll double down on that.
I want all the negativity, man. Say all the hate comments. Tell me everything. Call in. I need everybody to call in, positive or negative. Just call in.
Hey, you fuck with the negativity?
I like it.
Why? Tell me.
Man, I like having fun. Not everything got to be so serious. You feel me? At the end of the day, we try to make some content. You got to talk in the mic.
Yeah.
I want them to hear you, twin.
I want them to hear you.
I say haters make you famous, though.
My mama, though.
Yeah, I mean, without the hate, there'd be no love straight up.
Yeah, for me, I just feel like, and I was saying this earlier, you guys got a pod, too, so I feel like repeating this is, like, important.
Yeah.
In the beginning, I just wanted to get popping. I didn't know what that meant. And then when people started interrupting my piece when I went in public, I said, oh, shit, maybe we should rethink the...
That means you're doing something.
Yeah. Let's rethink some shit real quick. Yeah, well, for me, it's like it's not so much what I'm worried about out there. It's more so like the motive and intent, right? Because in the beginning, everybody just wants to get lit. But it comes with stuff. So it's like, okay, we're playing chess now. So now I got to really figure out how everybody's moving.
How many people you had to cut off from this podcast shit?
Good question right there.
I don't have enough hands and feet.
Damn. Yeah. Dude, I'm not too.
They hearing that shit.
Hey, you know why he hearing that shit?
That was an extra finale.
Hey, you know why he's hearing that shit?
Tell me.
No Diddy.
Hey, you know why he's doing that? Because when it's a party and it's filled with bitches and all that other shit, everybody got that shit tatted on their face, Leak Podcast.
You're not invited.
Hey, listen. It's ha ha till it's nah nah. Yeah. And when it got real, there was only two. Hey, clout is a hell of a drug.
Yeah.
It's a hell of a drug.
Yeah.
Say that.
Okay. I said all the time, if you're not out here standing with me, when I sign millions, you're not coming with me. You feel me? So it is what it is.
Type shit.
If they fall off, that's on them. I don't even look at it
right
now.
Hey, so what's up with the podcast? What are we doing with that?
Season two, we coming right back in.
So when season two?
We both need to drop first because we don't want to do no podcast until we drop out. You know?
I just came home, man. Scene. We just fresh off tour. I mean, we just get shit situated real quick, and we right
but
back
yes,
on it.
But yes, podcast season two, Diamond Doe Show, 20 episodes. You know what I'm talking about? All guests, viral shit. We doing the same shit, doing different shit. We know we adding people.
All that shit.
Everything. So, yeah.
I fuck with it.
Music is always the main focus, even before when we was popping the podcast. The podcast is just what we do when we want to sit down and have a conversation. You know what I'm saying? You know, I think it's a powerful thing when people watch podcasts because you're not doing nothing but talking. So if people are going to sit here and watch you talk, that means you could really do something. You could do anything. You know what I'm saying? Goddamn, if you could just use your words and you could just have a conversation and people want to watch that means something. You know what I'm saying? So the podcast really put me on in that mode. I was like, damn, I could never not do this shit.
For me, it's not so much like I'm just talking. It's like I feel like with the audience that we have right here and everybody, all the attention we have, it's like, they're watching not only because it's colorful, but because we're, like, giving them life.
Right, 100%.
You feel me? It's what you give them.
Right.
You feel me? And, like, I posted earlier today, like, all that whole Rolling Loud shit, it was like a crazy, like, wave that just sucked us into, like, the internet.
Right.
And now that we're out of it, I'm mentally in a state right now, and now that I recharged and, like, was able to, like, see hindsight and shit, where, like, I need to change my frequency because I care about my peace.
100%.
Me. You feel me? Everybody else is on different time and shit like that. But for me in my life, I got to change my frequency. You feel me? Like, the audience that we have and shit like that, not everybody's here for my bullshit.
You feel like controversy, though, is the number one, like, key to success for, like, especially podcasts? Like, what you trying on?
All publicity.
How we going to get the world to tap in? You know what I'm saying?
Well, all publicity is good publicity. And like, prior to all the shit that happened, the number one thing I was asking everybody, right or wrong, when they came in this on the couch was, how much bullshit are you willing to entertain?
Right. You see, this
everybody's
how I look
mind
at it.
Is different.
I sat down on this couch. The first thing I asked you was about that Dijon Paul shit, right?
Yeah.
Because it's something that
that's
that,
the bullshit.
It's like, whoa, like, what happened?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I want to know. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
Like, if I feel like that, everybody feel like that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
It's like,
and, but for me, like, the bullshit is I understand it's out there, and for the entertainment wise and the eyes and everybody wanting to hear. For me, it's touch and go, but I don't want to live there because if I live there, all my eggs are in his best.
I thought you was the type of motherfucker to have that happen and be like, oh my gosh, I can't believe we, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
No. I'm so happy we know you.
No. But let me say this. That's why I'm saying in the beginning, for me, it was like, I just want to be popping. Right. And the old me would have ate him up. I got, bro, listen. My phone is loaded with just like ready to shoot. You feel me? Like, I'm loaded. I really cook. You feel me? Like, they were laughing at No Jumper because I turned the No Jumper pillow a rainbow. Like, you feel that? I'm detailed with my what I do on the internet and shit
100%.
Like that, right? But what I'm saying is where I'm at today to reevaluate in my piece. I understand that we're going to address it, but we're going to keep moving on because there's only so much bullshit I'm willing to entertain. And at the end of the day, if I entertain that fully, my come up is going to be to the success of him. But not. Fuck that guy.
I love it. I love it.
You feel me? That's why the chess move is like, yeah, I'm going to address you when I'm ready to address you, but it's not even about you. Like, you feel me? Because people will take credit over that shit, and I'm not about to do it's chess, it's not checkers out here. You feel me?
Shit, I liked it. I seen it. I liked it. I thought it was cool. I'm like, okay,
don't.
You get more people gonna see you, so
yeah.
You know,
for me, like I was saying this, like everybody that comes in here, right? We've had so many artists, bro, big names, and everybody that sits on that couch says, y'all the next No Jumper, y'all the next No Jumper, y'all the next No Jumper, y'all the next No Jumper. And like the first two times, it's a compliment. But after like the 30th time, it's like, shut the fuck up. I'm the Leak Podcast.
Exactly. Hell yeah.
Be quiet.
Hell yeah.
That
part,
right?
That part.
And so like, it's nothing that I wanted to even like do with them because it's a podcast. I don't know Adam. I don't know these people personally, none of that shit or whatever.
100%.
But if we're here to shift culture, and they're the hottest, at some point, we're going to have to do this.
100%.
It just happened to be now.
Hey, that's true, though.
Hold on. Hey, you're on the Leak Podcast. Hey. Who we talking to?
Yo.
What's up?
Yo, my name is Jordy. I'm Salt Lake Sot.
What's up?
Oh.
Have a good night, brother.
Nah, talk to him. Talk to him. Say something. I want to hear something.
Hey guys, this is Salt Lake Sot in Salt Lake City, Utah.
Salt Lake.
It's Dirty.
I don't know who the fuck.
I'm the kid. I did your guys' Saint and Sinners tour.
He took pictures for us at the Salt Lake show. Shout out, man.
Yeah,
that's your people. He fuck with you. Not your people, but he fuck with you.
Yeah,
hey, guys, I'm actually going to come down in Cali for the first time and actually, like, pop out.
Okay.
When I graduate.
Surri.
Hey, hold on. Hey, let me ask you a question. Why do you fuck with Dom and Doe?
Dom and Doe, I mean, they're pretty chill. I like the music. I like what they create, you know. And Dom made a song before us, so, like, it's kind of cool that you guys are doing this together. Like, I'm actually proud of Dom.
Say that, brother. Say
that. That's right.
I love that.
That's the shit we entertain here.
I love it.
You feel
yeah,
me?
So, like, I'm excited to, like, go down to Cali, do pop out, do some photos there. And maybe, like, do photos with Rado and Dom, of course.
Hey, listen, bro, have a camera, we would love to have you around. I'm sure they would,
too. Yeah, tap in.
Hey,
good
just
photography.
Know what you're doing before you show up with it. A lot of people hold the camera just to get them indoors.
Hey, Jordy, hey, make sure you go to sleep, bro. It's past your bedtime. You got school tomorrow.
Y'all
nah, I just got off from work. I don't got school tomorrow.
Okay, okay.
I got photos to do on a daily.
Hey, when's your graduation before we pop it out?
My graduation is on May 22nd, so I'll send you guys the invite.
Yeah, congrats, man. Congrats,
podcast
man.
Podcast is pulling up to
shit. Let's go.
I'll send you guys all the invites to all you guys, including hey, the podcast and everything else.
Don't send me an invite. Send me a fucking plane ticket.
There we go.
Say less. I'm
going to
do an after party at my crib, too, with carne asada and everything.
Carne asada, Gordon. Surri,
surri. Arriba, arriba. All right, hey, thanks for the phone call, brother.
Yeah, we'll see you guys later, then.
All right, then.
Thanks, brother.
Hey, I wonder what the tacos taste like in Salt Lake, fool.
You lying. You was not going to
his. Hey, let's talk about it. Hey,
bro, it's not going to his graduation, bro. He lying.
Yeah. Hey. You're on the Leak Podcast. Bro,
not going to go to that jerk graduation.
Yeah.
Hey, you on the phone with King Twitter, man.
King Twitter, what up?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. I'm proud of my niggas, man. I see y'all on that couch,
listen,
laughing. I see y'all.
Yeah, P, come on, yeah, man. You know what it is. Right. P, stop playing.
Hell yeah.
Shit, so.
Hey, all I gotta say, hey, I got one question. Down.
Here we go.
Can I sweat?
You can do whatever you want, P. I'm right here, man. You can do whatever you
he
want.
He already said earlier he's with the bullshit. Run
I'm with
up.
The bullshit. You can do whatever you want. Look, it's a free world. Oh. It's fair game. Come on, P, you know what it is. Sweat on anything you want to, man. G-O-D.
I had to
oh, Yippee. She already told me about your head, too. She already said you was outside sweating, so it's good. It's good. Oh, it's good. You already done sweating, bitch. You sweated the bitch already. Nah, it's cool, though.
Oh, I did, though.
Pippin Twin, I appreciate you coming in, though. You my brother for real, though. I'm fire, though. Appreciate you calling in, gang.
You already know, man. I'm proud of y'all niggas, man.
Call my phone, brother.
Yeah, that part.
You already know.
Say that. Thank you, brother. Whoa. Hey. That was like listening to somebody speak Spanglish, and I kind of know what they're saying, but I kind of don't. I fuck with it. That shit crazy. Right or wrong? I'm trying to follow it, but then I'm like, maybe I shouldn't be listening to this phone call right now.
Oh. This pretty much like my phone right now, like yeah, calling in, having conversations, yeah. Like
calling the phone right now.
Hey, let's talk about tour. Let's talk about the road and shit like that. What's like some of the craziest shit you guys seen out there, bro?
For my homies, shit. Was the craziest shit I seen. Yeah. All my homies is crazy.
Say it.
All right, so look, I'm gonna tell you the worst story.
Yeah.
We in Reno, Nevada, right?
Yeah.
We get to Reno. We thinking like Reno, Nevada, like little Las Vegas. You feel me? I'm like, I'm finna get there. We gonna go gamble and all that. Yeah. We get to the casino. This bitch ran down. Like,
yeah.
Everything in Reno ran down. It's like crackhead central. Like,
yeah.
We end up going to the show, whatever. Woo wop. We go to the show. This shit was lit. The show was super, super dope. Shout out Reno. Goddamn. The homie bought some girls back, right? We in the hotel room. And I'm calling him out. I ain't gonna say him by name, but he knew who the fuck I'm talking about.
Yeah.
He gonna see this shit for sure. But he brought some girls with him, and like they stole my phone. And when they stole my phone, I knew they stole my phone. I told all the homies they stole my phone, and we stripped them down and we looked for their phone. But when I was looking for my phone,
wait, you skipped that part.
Hold on.
Wait a minute.
Rewind.
You skipped the part.
Rewind.
You skipped the part.
We bought it. I'm with
wait. That. How did, hey, your phone?
She gonna hate me for this
one. Hey, hold on, man. We gotta rewind real quick,
okay,
dog.
No. We had Circus Arena, Nevada turning up. We all drunk as hell. We had a good night, you know.
No. We heard all that part.
Okay, but look.
Hey, we heard all that.
The female.
Hey, but I want to know, phone is missing. When does the switch go? Bitch, take your clothes off.
Oh, yeah, you ready?
I want to know that.
Damn. So, like.
That's crazy. Oh, five, how many? Four or five, I want to say?
It's like seven of my homies. It's like two of them.
Hey.
It's like.
Hey, hold on. JR lost his phone, and all he can do is talk to Lost His Family because there's so many people. You know what bitches you had to holler at.
Hey, listen. Hey. So close that door.
Yeah.
All y'all been taking y'all clothes off.
Tell the story.
We right there, right? Like, I'm like, where my phone at? I'm like, I just had it on the bed, right? So I'm like, They over there doing their own thing. I'm not even with them. They just their own thing.
On the lit level, how lit are you? One
I'm 12.
Oh, so you're beyond lit.
I'm lit, right? Cool. But I'm still like coherent.
No, no, no. But I if you know lit, your phone's missing because you're lit, you're really tripping.
Oh, I'm it was cool. I first my phone missing. I told everybody, like, look for my phone. But when I said that, they went to the bathroom.
Say that.
And when they went to the bathroom, they did some janky shit, I'm going to tell you right now. So they get out the bathroom. I'm still looking for my phone. I didn't think nothing of it. But then, like, after, like, 30 minutes of looking, I'm like, nah, matter of fact, let me see everything you got. Like, your bags, everything. I'm like, let me look through it. And, you know, I turn that mode on. You feel me?
Yeah,
I'm like,
yeah.
Up. They're like, oh, we don't got it. They got all disrespectful with me. They're like, oh, you going to press me like that? We just going to leave. I'm like, then leave, bitch. Like, I need to see everything you got. So, woo-wop, check them. They didn't have nothing, so they left. They was mad as hell. They was having a good night. We ended their night. Goodbye. We looked for 3 more hours. Guess where my phone at?
Where?
It's in the toilet filter, bro. In the bathroom, bro. You know, like the little thing on top of the shit you gotta lift up. There's like water in there and shit.
What she dipped and hit it in there?
She threw it. So when she went to the restroom, she was like, they about to catch me.
Yeah.
They never look in the toilet filter. Yeah. They chipping my shit.
I thought she left it there in some junk shit, but she went in there and lifted it. Where it was, you had to hide it.
Yeah. Got up out of there. And, like, we was looking for it to, like,
bitch, get the fuck on.
Shit was lame. Lamest shit I ever dealt with.
So, now the question, real question. Those bitches, like, 1 out of 10. What do you think?
Oh, that's the homies. That was the homies, bitch.
Oh, here we go. Here we go. She was definitely
not.
Homies.
I was about to tell you, she's definitely not something I would be on. Like, I'll tell you, you thought I was going to save him. You thought I was going to save his ass.
Hey, but let me ask you.
So it was twos?
You did twos over the day.
Two twos.
Shorty wasn't bad. The way I look at it, she wasn't bad till she was. Like,
yeah, 22.
It was like, she wasn't bad. Like,
you said
there
were twos?
Two twos.
Damn.
Nah, I wouldn't call it. I'm trying to like remember.
It was easier to disrespect her.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Hey, but Quinn right here, he know me. He know I'm about to get off on the beach. So he like, he trying to calm me down. He's like, it's okay. Like,
yeah.
Let's just go over here and look for him. I know the bitch has got my phone.
Yeah,
you was even saying, you know the bitch got your phone. Like,
that's
like,
crazy.
Get off on
it. Well, for us, that's like the ha-ha till it's nah.
Yeah,
it's all fun and games until it's real life. It's like,
and that's how I knew the iPhone 15 took them chargers right there.
What you mean?
Because I had to get an iPhone 15.
Oh, after shit. That.
And then I seen they had that
charger. Same way he
I got the iPhone
shit.
14. I was like, fuck that. Yeah, I had to get a new phone the same day. I was hot.
Crazy.
I was mad.
All right, but hey, you got another song. I'm ready to hear another song.
Let's do it. I'll airdrop some shit. Let's go. Come on.
All right, hold on. We got waiting music, or you guys want to talk in between?
Everybody on their phone? We do whatever. Now I got a question for you.
Go ahead. I'll talk while you guys send it. What's your question?
Drake or Kendrick? What that whole shit? Where you going? What that whole Drake shit?
Let me say this. Hold on.
It's like, who you got? Which side you got? Because, like, it's Future.
For
it's,
me, if I
it's
had...
Future,
it,
Kanye,
no, I don't
want to
pick a side. I don't want to pick a side. But for
who
the sake
got?
Of conversation...
I know who you got.
Hey, I don't want to pick a side, but for the sake of conversation, like... I got to give it to Drake. And the reason I got to give it to Drake is because he's actively outside. He's on stage. He's not tucked. He's not hiding. He's by himself. He's out on a track with 3 people. He's holding it down. He's really doing his shit. He running it up. Hey. And Drake played different. Drake DJ ain't just making a song. Ye said this. Like, Drake doesn't just make a song about you. He just doesn't go for the headshot. He like... DM your baby mama.
Nah, Drake
He invited Rick Ross's baby mama to the fucking concert. Drake is playing a different type of game. It's a different type of cook.
Nah, you right though. I would take Drake too, but I think Kendrick the better rapper. Drake the better artist though.
But this is the thing. When you're tucked for so long, that's the problem with time, right? Is like Kendrick got enough bread to tuck and like protect his peace and shit like that.
Right.
But when you're tucked for so long, it's kind of like, Drake's been outside for a long time and he's a crowd favorite.
Let me ask
so
you this. You think people in the West Coast are like obligated to take Kendrick's side? Like, are people in LA especially?
Well, Kendrick has become like the Laker jersey.
Yeah.
You kind of like have to because it's Kendrick.
You got to, right?
Yeah,
like, that's
but,
how
no,
I feel.
No, no, no,
I feel
no,
like
no.
I'm
but,
from the West
but,
side. Like.
But for me, I'm a realist and he's a person. He's a human being. So if he ain't outside, I'm a big believer in, if you're not outside, then watch out.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
that's
yeah.
The case. Jake, our future then.
I feel you.
Huh?
Jake, our future then. Jake, our future.
Future Metro.
Drake still.
But Kendrick took immediate shots, though. Like, he took,
but you know what's crazy? That project that Future put out, I don't know if you guys seen it or not.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Every song on that every title is the opposite of Drake's last album's title.
No, you're right.
Shooter. Where's the airplane now? That shit is crazy. That's what I'm saying. The shit that they're doing. the shit that they're doing, they're playing chess in front of everybody. It's not just like song for song. Like, yeah, they're making it interesting right now for everybody. Yeah. What's up?
What up? We over here politicking right now.
Yeah, so let me know the politics.
Nah, these secrets. All right,
you had a podcast.
What's the secrets over here?
Hey. Everything said and done in this room will be documented and recorded.
I ain't going as wild as I went last time.
Yeah, type I was shit.
Because your homegirl out here.
Who, Mila?
Whoa. Is that her name?
She's on the way.
She's on the way.
Don waiting for her.
Hey, no, it's cool. She was talking. She's a real. I feel like she got the podcast energy. Because the minute we got off that camera, she was the nicest person ever. But she had some shit to get off her chest on the camera.
Well,
I liked it.
Yeah. Popping this shit.
Cool. That's my type of vibe right
there. Yeah, hey, but see, this is the thing. Hey, let me tell you this. What we do, right? See, them mic holders, there's like a lot of microphones. So I don't have a problem like giving anybody the spotlight, right? You know what I realized about Mila? Man, I said I wasn't gonna say it as much this episode, but fuck. she's one of the realest niggas I know.
Oh God.
Hey. The fact that she's a female, bro, never mind. She's the realest nigga I know.
Shout out Mila, man.
Let me hold my tongue.
Shout out Mila.
Hey.
I hope she come in with the same energy as last time. I mean,
No. But what it is, it's like, birds of a feather flock together, right?
Yeah.
And like me, to be around me is like, you have to be a special person, bro, because there's like a lot of bullshit that comes with me. You feel me? There's a lot of extra shit that comes with it and my personality and all that. And so it's not easy to be around. And me and Mila, I'm not worried about somebody being next to me and just agreeing with me and being my yes man. Me and her have like bump heads, and she's still by my side.
100%. That's how it's supposed to go.
Yeah, and there's a lot of people that have been in this room where the first time I go heads with them, they out.
Oh, hell no.
Crazy.
Damn.
But hey. But that's why Mila's a real one. You feel me? Because she understands that, and I fuck with her energy and everything she's on. 1,000%.
Yeah.
I be telling bro, we need to have more podcast arguments. You know, we don't argue enough. I'm like, bro.
And we argue.
You guys get along too much.
No. And we argue in real life, though. We don't get on that podcast and see. We don't argue at all. But in real life, you know.
Yeah. But I feel like people out there, like, there's like pools, right? There's pools of like certain people that like a certain type of content. But like the fact that you guys are two homies and you guys never fight and get along, there's a whole crowd for that. It might not be the crowd that you're used to right now,
100%.
But there's a whole community that'll just dive into the fact that both of you guys actually fuck with each other and don't argue.
Nah, facts though. Yeah, we rarely argue, okay? But like, I'll be telling them I'm going to argue.
You want some bullshit that you're not.
He don't argue.
Nah, he be looking for the bullshit.
Nah, every time we argue, we almost got down. So we don't do too much arguing.
Type shit.
All right,
bet.
Arguing vibes.
We ready for music now? Load it up. Enough talking?
Yes, sir. Yeah,
let's do it. Hey, shout out to your Asali dress. Asali, what up?
Yeah. Shit, hold on. Come show it. Fuck that. Come flex it. You got to get in the camera.
You got to walk this way. Hey. Go that way. Sit on it. Go. Like in the middle. She's like,
camera right there. Oh, yeah.
That part.
Go ahead in.
Type shit.
Pop your shit.
I fuck with it. Hey, let's say this. Hey, before we play the music, how would you guys describe the Juice sound?
West Coast.
I feel like it's different.
I feel like there's a gang of different sounds. There's a bunch.
So describe it in words if you can, if you can.
You talking about Orange County?
You talking about
yeah. What you guys do in the juice? Like, describe the juice sound, because I feel like it's not just West Coast. Like, yeah, it's West Coast. It's like, on this side. Yeah. But like what you guys do, there's like a pocket in sound because you
it's
guys
like
are
trap
in the streets,
though. It's like trap though as well. Like, huh? It's like trap. I feel like.
So explain it. What's the sound of the juice right now? You guys are there in the streets. So what is it?
It's our sound, though. It's West Coast shit, like dead ass. Like
we was bumping in the streets, you know what I mean? But as far as like the genres type shit, I feel like it ranges.
But it varies,
you know,
though, because it's melodic artists.
There's hella artists in the
juice. Like, you know, like Young Pinch, shout out Young Pinch and all that. But Young
he be making Pinch melodic
is
a, shit.
Yeah,
you know
Pinch
I mean?
Is big as fuck. Yeah.
Like it's different genres, so it could be like multiple sounds from the juice.
But I'm asking
like,
right now where you guys are at. In
oh, it's
your,
that West Coast
like,
trap shit, though. Yeah, it's like, we bringing the streets. We bringing the streets alive. That's what we doing. You know what I'm saying? That's our goal. You know, like, shout out Ford. That's my big brother, man. I'm signed to yours truly and all that. Shout out him.
But Forrest's music ain't like street music.
Song, exactly. That's what I was about to say right now.
Yeah, he got like little white girl singing that shit. 100%. Like and the relationship shit.
Peace. Oh, yeah. That's a big bag. Big
it's
bag.
A different bag.
Big bag.
It's a different bag. Hey, wait, hold on. Forrest from the OC?
Yeah, he's from Anaheim. He grew up from the same neighborhood as we did.
Okay,
yeah.
Cool. Yeah, but he's not on that other shit. You guys are.
Hell no. Yeah, but that's how we connected. We from the same city. You know what I'm saying?
I knew Forrest.
Talking about
a long time. I mean, I knew Forrest since like shit. Since I was like 14, he's probably like 12 type shit.
Yeah, but for me, like I've always seen a masterpiece is when you take two things that don't go together and you put them together. Yeah,
opposites collide, though.
Opposites
right?
collide. And I feel like that's where you guys are actually making that shit go crazy on the
road. You should see on tours, it's all like. All like love music and all that, and then
come
boom,
through and shake the room.
Run that shit up,
everything,
bitch!
Yeah, everybody.
I love you later, but right now, bust that shit open.
It's just cool because like for a sign of me, it's just like you could tell the connection with the fans. They already know who I am. You know what I'm saying? Or they heard about me or understand like the dynamic already. So it's like. It's fun, bro. You know what I'm saying? They getting out there and they know your words and you know what I'm saying? They really vibing to you. This shit's dope.
Yeah.
Like, facts.
Being an artist, a lot of artists do not experience this shit, like, for real. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that shit was a blessing, like, in itself, for real.
Type of shit. I bet. Let's hear some music and then we'll hop back into the combo. What's up, Jerry? You ready?
Let go. Oh, yeah.
You are now
we bringing the hood in here, bitch, though.
Run that shit up.
Yeah, this for the folks, man.
Run it up, Kel.
Negative sex.
So he tapped in.
I ain't homie from the section, really got it right. Old prison yard swerves you, not a match. He said, I'm drunk pen, bitch, I'm gonna feel more in Jackson. Well, we really get it crack and turn painters into gangsters. How I'm gonna mess with that green eye lace. Boy, please watch the top flop. Go, see you later. And I ain't doing no plan. Big on the say so, play for the halo. Put the little guns down for ground by the Draco. And I'm hot slimy, mud walking with a bankroll. And when they see me, niggas take no. Every time my niggas lying, yeah, they not around. Every time a sucker die, said we gun them down. Every time it was up, you was not involved. Came and find them in the trains, we done killed them all. They gon' salute when I pass
the show. We see you with the chat, brother.
Love for them mother guys. Every time it was up, it was time to ride. 400, that's a game, we don't sympathize. That's a folks game. All my asses with the business. Shit ain't the same no more, they ain't with it. Every time I slid through the funkies, they all hit it. But every time one of them died, said we did it. Every time I'm in there, say I saw that shot. Pull up in that thing with a gang of my fathers.
Top of
dead niggas can rob, I don't do fine talks. Still a nigga bitch, I'm gone, say I rock those sanchos. They don't care for the head honcho. Me and me goes, I shoot a nigga through the poncho. We got those over on Western and neighbors. Live for the gang, smoke trophy than the Lakers. Every time my niggas lying, yeah, they not around. Every time a sucker died, so we cut him down. Every time it was up, you was not involved. Came and find them in the trains, we done killed them all. They gon' salute when I'm passing by. Cool ass, I got no love for them other guys. Every time it was up, it was time to ride. 3400, that's a game, we don't sympathize.
Stop playing. Stop playing.
Got
another one down, what's up?
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
If I wasn't drop music, I would get erased. You never seen it. How about T.I.S. Slice young like it Halloween. I don't need this low. I fuck the hoe. I know just how to get them. I can tell you one thing. Your web and now they trusting beats. You never trusting switches. Fully with banana clips. In the kitchen, power is my little brother. Take a hit. That's on people. Rapper, just like a gift. I'm a dog, just like a pig. You say the game, we take a trip. You say the game, we take a trip.
This a pint of wine. I don't know.
We got prop money. We got prop money in the building one time. I'm fucking with you, dog. I'm fucking with you, dog. I'm fucking with you. It's all props. Hey, all props.
Ziggy, what up?
I'm gonna play one more. I'm good. Can I fuck with you, JR? Can I fuck with you, my boy?
They are.
Hey, I like music because it like breaks shit up real quick.
Type shit.
All right, JR, talk to me about the music, bro.
Shit, the second one just threw everything. Hey, I fuck with that.
That TRX.
That one was cold.
Yeah.
Fuck with that.
That's a video I'm dropping next. No cap. Appreciate you, man.
That one got like a little, like you said, like a trap movement. But I have a question for you. So, like, you got different, like, your songs is just different. Like, it's got, you know what I'm saying?
Everybody
like,
say that.
You got the artist of the cadence and the rapping. You figured it out. Yeah. But, like he was asking, what do you classify your genre? Like, where is your lane into being art? Are you more into, like, the trapping, the hustling shit, and like, oh, the artist just like on the back end, it's cool, extra little bag, it's cool, but you really tap, you know what I'm saying? Or are you really trying to be an artist?
I'm really
like,
trying to be an artist.
To the next,
level.
To be bigger than Drake.
I'm trying to be the hardest worker, you feel me? So at the end of that year, I'm trying to be like a complete artist.
So what do you consider yourself, and what lane do you, where's your strength at?
I hate putting myself in a lane. I tell everybody the same thing, bro. Hey, bro, talk for me, bro.
You hate it, but you have
my bro,
to.
My bro right here, he could sing, he could rap, he could do that rock shit. You know what I mean?
I do everything, bro. But the thing about me is I want to be a West Coast.
Hold on. Hey, listen.
I'm telling you.
You can't say the homie can sing and then me not ask him to fucking sing, because I've never heard this nigga sing in my life.
Oh, God, I never heard him sing.
I wouldn't even rap on this couch. Fuck, I'm gonna do singing.
Wait.
We not singing for real. We auto tune singing. I'm not a singer. I'm from the trap.
But don't what you're saying.
Hey, but he do all that shit, but he won't drop none of that shit.
I swear to God.
He hard as fuck doing all that shit.
But as far as melody wise, is what you're saying in the studio, he got melodies and shit
that. He got all that shit. Yeah.
But all I drop is like hard shit because I want to be a West Coast rapper. I am a West Coast rapper, right? So like at the end of the day, I want to be a West Side rapper. I don't want to be a Cali rapper. I want to be a West Side rapper. You know what I'm saying? Like how Mozzie, from over there. But like he could be played in LA. You know what I'm saying? The same way he could be played over there. The same way. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to just be like right there. But as far as the lingo, like West Coast rap.
Well, what do you think? What do you think is gonna break? Like what do you, as an artist or both you two done, like right both y'all,
tell
as
me.
Far as an artist, what's gonna break? Like what do you feel is gonna be the breaking point to
you
like take to the next level?
I feel like we just got.
Go ahead.
No, you go ahead, brother.
No, that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm asking. Like what's gonna break the barrier? Because right now y'all, like you said, you signed for a, you moving, you doing the tours and shit. You 100%. Know what I'm saying? I did the tours and stuff like that. But I'm trying to break the wall
right.
to be the next DJ Khaled.
Oh yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's my point of view.
But we punching. You know what I'm saying? Like, right now we
what's your breaking view as far as what's gonna be where you trying to, what's your goal to break, like, okay, I'm gonna be the next hottest artist out of the OC type shit.
100%. I feel like you gotta be controversial. You gotta be in the
mix.
Yeah,
but see, but that's what I'm saying. Like,
controversy don't gotta be bad. It don't gotta be no like sell your soul type controversy.
Yeah, I know. But this whole podcast that we've been talking, it's like, you guys are not you guys. I'm saying you. Like, you're looking for the bullshit to get this shit buzzing. I don't know if you touched it and it felt like it already worked. So I'm with the bullshit.
Yeah,
looking for more of it.
Not like that.
I'm not like that.
But I'm by.
Talk about it.
He's completely different. I'm not speaking for him because that's my brother. But we don't agree on damn near nothing. You feel me? Like sometimes you feel me. So, but now for me, it's like.
But for the internet, you seen the bullshit.
I'm never down to do nothing that like be against my morals, but I'm down to have some controversy.
Yeah,
I like that shit. I live for that shit. Like you know what I'm saying? I'm just that type of person to like want to do that shit. I feel like that's how you break the barrier of being an artist. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like you have to be able to be in the mix all the time. That's just it. Like you can't just be dropping music. That's just not how it works. It's 2024. You can't not just drop music.
Yeah, but that's my thing. So like
same thing with podcasts. You can't just drop a podcast. Like it has to be a narrative. Like everybody has to have a narrative. I'm not saying it gotta be no like gay shit, no sell your soul shit, but like it gotta be something that that is worth watching, right? So that's just my goal, like just doing that.
This nigga putting shows and shit on you, it's crazy. What's up, nigga? We gotta make that shit better again. But that's my thing. How much bullshit are you willing to entertain? And for me, Doe is saying he's not really trying to entertain that shit. Yeah. But you're with the bullshit because you've seen it work for you in the internet shit.
Hell yeah.
I'm with doing bullshit, but like I'm talking about as far as like
the internet,
niggas trying internet beef and all that weird
shit.
Oh,
hell
no. You feel me? All that.
Yeah,
like,
that ain't what I'm talking about.
I don't respond to none of that shit. You feel me? Because that shit fake for the fake. I mean, like, see me in real life, then, I mean, we can talk about it type shit. But as far as that, I'm cool on all that shit.
And that's the crazy part. But I feel like with me, like, I feel like that's the fight that I'm fighting against.
Exactly.
You get me? I understand. Exactly. I understand what wins and I understand what's popular. But for me, I feel like, if you're cool enough and there's a vibe enough and there's a buzz enough and everybody's on the up, fuck the negativity, we're going that way. Me.
Yeah, that part.
Yeah, but I'm willing. I know it comes at a price. I know it's going to take me longer to get there.
For sure.
But that's the road I'm willing to take because it's all been documented forever. And because it's been documented forever for the world to see, I'm willing to take the long road.
No, for sure.
Without the controversy.
But you know, you still need narratives, though.
Oh, 1,000%. There's a shit
that's just not going to ever not
be
a factor.
1,000%. 1,000%. Like, how do I say this? Like, I'm not looking for shit, but if it comes up to the plate, I know how to cook. Watch out.
Yeah.
For sure.
You get me?
100%.
I want peace, but I'm ready for war.
100%.
Type shit. But for me, it's like, it goes back to the bullshit. How much are you willing to entertain? When I asked somebody that, they had a good response. They said, you got to be careful with how much bullshit you entertain because you just might become the bullshit.
Right.
Yeah.
There's a line. Straight up. And then that's the art. It's like, how much are you willing to entertain? Because then, you know what I mean? All that other shit.
Nah, yeah, 100%.
The internet's a tool. You know what I mean? You got to know how to use that bitch. You know what I mean? But
what's crazy is the shit that you guys did at the fair.
Oh, yeah.
I said,
stupid.
He knows how to cook.
Yeah.
That was the beginning of the touchdown run.
Hell yeah.
That was the beginning of the touchdown run.
Hey, we set the OC fair down, man. We set the OC fair down. We hopped on. We was climbing on shit at the OC fair.
Yeah.
We climbed on some big shit. Yeah. We just got to the very top. You know what I'm saying? Just did some maniac shit. I ain't going to lie. You got to be viral, though. I'm not saying you got to do no stunts that is like corny, goofy shit, but like you got to be able to go to the OC fair and shut it down, go to a fair, shut it down, you know what I'm saying? Get crazy, you know, be just eye opening. That's all I'm saying.
Hold on. Yeah, that part.
Hold up. Hey, y'all good over there? You good? Do you need anything? What about a microphone? What about a microphone? Would you like a mic?
Yeah, grab a mic. Someone grab a mic. Get a mic.
Yeah, bring
the mic.
I don't know her, so I'm gonna watch my mouth.
Nah, go ahead.
Bro walks back to the couch. He's like, I'm in trouble. Get the fuck out of here. Where's the mic at?
Hey, the thing about it is, baby. Hey, it's all love. It's all love for real. But like, I'm gonna entertain this so long until I hear this shit buzzing, and if that catches my attention, you got my eyes now. What's up?
Yeah. Oh God.
Hey, somebody came one episode and was like, I just wanna be a fly on the wall, and then took a phone call, and her homegirl was like, are you bored? I said, no, she's thoroughly entertained, bitch.
You are now chill.
That shit is crazy.
You funny. I like your energy, guys.
Yeah, it's up. You feel me? It's crazy because, like, I feel like right now we got a lot of attention, but a lot of people are taking my, I have two, we film Mondays and Wednesdays. Yeah. So, like, when it comes to, like, conversation, like, I'm doing my hours. You feel me? Like, I know how to talk. I know what's going on because I'm like, this is the gym for me, right?
100%.
And so all these people that we're bringing in, not all of them, but there's some of them that come in and I feel like they're not just coming to get an interview. They're coming to, like, battle Khalid Scott to feel like they got a slicker tongue. And I'm like, bro, let's just talk. Like, chill out. Yeah, like, just chill out. You feel me? Like, for me, the show has become this. I mean, you've known me for a minute now, yeah, right? For sure. So, like, for me, the show has become like I'm willing to talk to anybody, but I don't entertain bullshit.
100%.
So whenever I see like people enter, like just stroke their dick on that couch, I'm like, I'm not into that.
100%. No,
I'm not into that. You feel me? 100%. When they come in and I'm the greatest in the world and I run the city and all that, but like the music doesn't back it up, I'm like, yeah. It doesn't really sound like that.
Yeah. I know bangers. This is not a banger.
I know bangers. That's not a banger.
I know bangers.
Yeah. But no, for real, I feel like that's what the podcast has become for me, is just calling a lot of bullshit out, right? And so like all these people that we have on the couch, when you say you're looking for controversy and all that, that's what the show has become, and that's got us a lot of attention. But right now I'm like, I'm at a point where, not like forever, but right now I just need to let some bullshit slide and just,
yeah,
let,
yeah.
You feel me? Like, where's the airplane at? I need that over here.
Shoo.
You feel me? Right now I just need to chill the fuck out, because we're playing chess, not checkers.
Oh, God.
You feel me? Because like, we're going out to these events and shit like that, and I'm at a point now, like, we move with security now. We have to do that now.
Oh,
like,
yeah, for sure.
Before, it was like, we're with everybody and the people and all that shit. Now it's like, stay the fuck back. I need my space.
Yeah.
That's where it's at today. Today. You feel me? That's the growth. Like,
that's a good thing. It's a good thing.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. Yeah. Yeah, type B type shit. But
for sure got some security, some homie security.
I got I got homies. If you need them,
show running with them.
I got the little homies. You want to,
bro? No. Hey, bro. Hey. Oh, the craziest shit. When I went to your birthday party.
Oh yeah. Hey, you did go to my birthday party. Matter of fact, goddamn, you is a testament to time. You tell them. Bro.
Hey. How many people I pull up with, dog?
Zero.
Goddamn.
That was respectable. I ain't gonna lie.
To the juice. Hey, the craziest part, right? Shit was thick outside too me at the time, right?
Yeah, shit.
The little homie pulled up his shirt and pulled out an extender. I said, no, put that down. Put that down. No. Don't do that.
Allegedly.
Not here.
Allegedly.
It's on camera. He did it on his own. Not allegedly.
He probably did.
Yeah.
He probably did. It is dumb ass.
This shit is crazy, bro, but outside is a real place.
Yeah, for sure.
Huh?
Yeah, call coming in.
I don't hear it.
Let's go. 714 number. There's going to be some shit.
Let's see. Yeah. No, it's not ringing. That's an old. That's old. Okay. Yeah, you would hear it.
Where the calls at? We need the calls coming in, man.
Yeah,
fuck that.
Yeah, hold on. Let me see what
I need some calls in this motherfucker.
Type B type shit. All right, bet. Hey, so you guys, as a whole, what's for the future for you guys? Let's talk the future real quick.
I'm just going to keep rapping my ass
keep
off, bro.
Up, man.
Yeah, but like, what? That's you just keeping your head down.
Season
and doing
two,
that, but
Diamond
like,
Doe Show, rapping, music videos, features, everything. We just, you know.
Yeah, but what I'm asking, that's not what I'm asking. What I'm asking is like, for what? What's like the end goal? Like,
there's no end goal. Keep going until
to
you
run
die.
It up, man.
Ain't no end goal. We just gotta keep going.
Get that check.
It should never be no end. Why you thinking about an end goal? We going forever. Hopefully my shit lasts forever. And if it don't,
you can't stop getting money. That's
ain't no end goal.
You gotta run it up.
We need something more. There's Simone.
That's crazy. You know what's crazy?
Simone.
The conversation with a lot of people, like the mentality is like, when we make it. And like for me, I've understood like making it is not a destination. You're never gonna make it.
You're never gonna be satisfied with what I'm not gonna be satisfied with.
Say that.
I done thought like having the, you know, I got the car I wanted, the jewelry I wanted, you know what I'm saying? All the clothes I wanted, everything. You think all that shit gonna make you happy? You like, nah, there's more. I want better. You know what I'm saying? I need some more. Yeah. Until you realize that, you gotta really get out of that mindset of thinking like what you want is like your destination. When you get that car, you gonna want, I got like a Benz right now. I want the Maybach though. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So it's like, it never gonna stop. Once I get the Maybach, I'm gonna wanna pull up on some other shit. You feel me? Like,
that's a good question. All right, let's go here. Define happiness. What makes you happy?
Shit, family.
Say
money,
both success. Y'all, go ahead.
Family, money, success.
Family, money, success.
Family,
no
money,
better,
success.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. That's it. That's, and my brother's my family. About. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you're not my brother, you're not my family. If you're my friend, I don't. We cool, but you know what I'm saying? Like, if you're my family, I'll die for you. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what made me happy. Family, money, success. That's it.
And how often do you keep that energy around you?
Every day.
Every day.
Wake up like that.
Break the how?
You said what now?
How?
How what?
Like, how do you keep that around you on a regular basis? Because, like, what, like, the reason
you just gotta weed shit out though, like, not everything.
But the reason I'm trying to ask you to go deeper is because with everybody that comes in here, it's easy to say that, right?
100%.
There's like layers to it, right? Like, it's easy for people to say, yeah, we're lit, it's love, it's money, this, and I'm around it all the time. But this is a podcast, and you guys are podcasters, so let's tell it.
Maintain,
like,
I think.
Talk about it.
You gotta maintain all.
Let's connect with people real quick.
Yeah, 100%. You gotta maintain all three of those things. Like, in order to be happy with all three of those things, you got to make sure you're showing face to all three of those things, right? So what I say family, right? You got to make sure you got good connections with your family, your brothers, your, you know, your immediate family, everything. That's going to make you the happiest for sure. After that, you're going to have to get some money for sure because nothing else matters after that. You know what I'm saying? Obviously, God, the God number one, but you know what I'm saying? When I'm talking about on this earth, what could make me happy, what could, you know what I'm saying, satisfy me is you're going to need some money for sure. And then you're going to need success, you know? Success and money, two different things.
For me, man, like, honestly, like, my program is, shit, I'll be home. I'll be home with the family.
Facts, you do.
I'll be home with the family.
He rarely pops out.
With my girl and shit. I'm, only time I'm popping out is.
I'm like, why you got all them chains? You ain't never pop out of no club.
Hey, man, if I'm
got the grill in and all that, you don't even pop out of the club, goddamn.
If I'm getting paid to pop out, you know what I mean, then we there for sure, you know what I mean? If it's some business or something, but I ain't just popping out with
but
no,
I feel
just because
like
it's Friday.
But your guys' relationship
you know
is the
like,
yin and the yang.
Yeah.
No, 100%. I'm the opposite.
You guys together, like, you feel me?
This my young bull right here,
you
know what I mean? He in the field.
I'm in the field every day.
Yeah, outside.
Yeah, yeah. But I fuck with it. I fuck with it 1,000% what you guys are doing. Jared, what are you thinking over there, brother?
No, like you said, they yin to yang. I mean, you got a nigga that did time, and you got a nigga that didn't do time.
How you know I didn't do time? What the fuck? What the fuck you talking about?
Whoa! No, but I'm saying,
just fresh
he's like a father.
I ain't do no time, but how did he know?
I was in the same position as him.
Yeah.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I got homies that don't got kids, and they
mindset
is
like, shit, I don't give a fuck.
That's me and him.
Exactly.
Swear to God.
Yeah.
That's me.
Yeah.
Can't afford it.
I can't afford for
exactly.
That second, that 2 minutes, whatever it is, to be gone. So, like,
yeah.
Sure, like,
yeah, straight up. Oh God,
Don't so respectable, bro. He stand on straight business up. 1,000,000% of his life.
The comment section says, Dom, do you want kids in the future?
I've always thought about that. I don't know. I'm not
okay,
there yet.
Here's a better question.
Go ahead.
Sushi boy or nah?
What that mean?
You go raw?
Hell no.
That's a sushi boy.
That's law. I don't have
some people like just don't fuck with condoms. You feel
that's
me?
That's not me.
Like
I'm clean.
That's
I'm right here.
Sushi boy. Hey, that's why he stay in the house.
That's why
he stay in the house.
that was the reaction.
Hey, what you got? You got a good thing at home, you run it up. Say that.
Yeah.
I respect it.
Golly.
That's crazy. Hey.
I probably got a fourth baby on the way, man. You never know.
No, don't play.
You are not chilling.
Hey, let me ask you this.
That part.
Don't say about the woodworks. She's like, fuck it, I'm gonna be viral on this
motherfucker. That's crazy. Hey, do you guys see each other every day? Both of you guys?
Nah, man.
How many times a week we see each other?
We see each other.
Three times a week.
We tap in with each other every day, though. Yeah,
every day we tap in.
No, see each other face to face. Kick it, link.
Three times a week. Four times a
week. Yeah.
Yeah.
You let life do life, and then you guys tap in, make sure you guys tap in and shit like that.
After tour, man, I had to go home and get away from all these motherfuckers.
Oh, God.
I'm like,
that's a lot, right?
I went up every day on tour. I didn't take no breaks. All gas. Straight up went all gas.
Hey, you know what's crazy, though? I feel like with tour, road trips, all that, when you get close with, like, your homies.
Oh, you in that mode.
It's cool to be homies, But when you go on road trips and do like that shit, is you really realize yeah, you if see you fuck with somebody or not.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, like when we're in the city and show up and get ready to go. Nah, yeah, that's cool. Out, that's one thing, because like I can deal with
when
it.
When you travel with 3.5
when
months
we on
something?
The road and you stink, clean your shit up.
Don't say nothing about nobody. We're not dropping no bombs. But yeah, bro.
I ain't gonna stop hitting bombs until you give me a name.
Hey.
I'm fucking with you. Hey, I ain't gonna lie. I probably got arguments with like 50% of my homies on tour.
You're the messy one?
I'm not the messy one. I'm the one that stand on business.
Who's the dirty one in the group?
Shout out here as Diamond. He the dirty one in the group. You think you're messy. Here do the drama.
That's crazy.
Now me and him almost got down one.
No,
one
not
night.
Something messy. I said something dirty. Like
he said, dirty. Who the dirty?
Who dirty be?
Who like leave shit everywhere? Who doesn't clean up after themselves?
I can't air the homies out like that. I can't do that. To
but
no one
but,
here though.
All these niggas dirty.
You don't got to air them out. But hey. But traveling, tour, all that exposes all that because when you just go party, you don't see none of that.
Oh, God in heaven.
Yeah, man.
But, you know, we like to keep a real player like, though. I try to have the homies abide by that same standard than most of them do.
Yeah.
So, like, good, but.
Yeah.
Yeah, it be like that, though. Like, we get on everybody here, though. We not the type of group that's not going to shoot on you. We going to shoot on you immediately. And you're going to hear it all day. You're going to hear it a million times, especially me. I'm gonna tell you a million times. I'm gonna get on your head a million times.
Yeah.
If you smell,
you start thinking, we gonna throw a jug of water on your ass.
Yeah, you gotta go.
Hey, give me something that irritated you on tour, though.
Something that irritated,
you on tour.
We almost got there. Tell them about the night we was at Booby Trap. Hey, shout out Booby Trap in Miami.
What irritated him? You answered this nigga's question.
You gotta talk about Miami though.
Miami. I don't even remember what we was fighting about, bro.
We was drunk, though. But he's capping.
Hey, out there, are you like a drinker or a smoker? Like, when you get lit, like, what's your thing?
Bro, we off everything, man. We off.
Don't say everything.
Not everything.
Everything is like a lot.
Not
Diddy
everything.
Just got caught with pink cocaine. Don't say everything.
Nah.
We
smoking, we drinking for
everything show. Is a vague word. You gotta just say specific.
What's pink cocaine?
Smoking,
though?
What
drinking,
the hell is that? I mean,
you ain't never heard of pink cocaine?
Tusi? Is that Tusi?
Huh?
That's that Tusi shit?
Yeah. Vice?
Hold on. I ain't saying nothing.
Hey, on Vice.
Hey, trip out.
And hold behind this face because we get into motherfucking viral in this motherfucker.
Hey,
you don't even
want to
be on that camera right there.
We was in Chicago. The homie found some pink cocaine. Remember that shit? In the Uber.
We found Tusi in the Uber, bro.
Found Tusi in the Uber.
And the homies was doing
that. He was probably just in that motherfucker.
Swear to God.
Yo, finding drugs and taking them is fucking crazy. If I find weed, I'm throwing it away and moving on.
Yeah. I ain't take that shit.
Fuck that. Nah, but we was on tour with like 20 homies, though.
Yeah, no, but let me just say this. Anytime
someone running through that bag.
Hey, you know somebody going to take that shit.
Someone taking that
shit. Yeah, I know somebody's going to take it, but whoever that person is that's taking it, don't give a fuck about life. They're willing to gamble.
Come back.
They're willing to gamble.
Shout out my homie in the head right here, man.
Oh, shit.
Oh, shit. Yeah, nah. Toy was lit, though. Look at here. They got the theme music on. He trying to do you. I'm sorry, though.
We fucking with you. It's good vibes.
Bro's going to come in with three
ski masks. I like to put the homies on the spot, though.
Yeah. I got a ski mask if you need it, bro. Let me know.
I got one, too.
Yeah.
Sorry.
That's crazy. All right, hey, what are we doing? We're going to hear another song. You want to talk a little bit more? What's up?
Yeah, let's hear a song. Did I say something?
You got more?
Yeah, let's do one more.
All right, let's do one more. Let's run it up.
Are y'all familiar with a lot of them songs?
You sure what?
Are y'all freestyling them songs?
Bro, yeah, I'll be like,
you're a cool guy. And you talk really cool, talk, but you just be like with the mic down here.
Maybe go.
Put that shit up.
No, did he?
Hey, they said Matt got a bag in his pocket.
Oh! And then they're running outside. No.
Yeah. Oh. Okay, we're gonna take some
shots. Hey, man. Come over here and talk, gang. Nah, fuck that. The homies is being shy and all that. The homies are being shy.
Hey, you know you're on camera no matter where you stand at in the room?
Dude.
All right, let's move on.
Hey, I'm trying to be a member on the league podcast though. I feel like I could play a position. You know what? I could probably be like the, I don't know, something.
I could
do something though. What the hell? All right, you know what?
You can be the controversy guy. Anytime
you got podcast on God Diamond Doe Show, man. We.
That's what you don't do.
I'll switch up real quick.
Honestly though, I feel like just us mixing our platforms together.
No, I'm playing. I was fucking around.
No.
I felt like it was getting quiet. I had to say something.
Yeah. But I'm talking for real right now. Like us mixing our platforms together. You guys coming over here. Us going over there.
No, for
like,
sure.
It's being a part of the podcast community. There's a lot of other platforms that are afraid to like. Just be cool with each other, bro.
No, 100%.
Just talk to each other and just, like, get this shit out. You feel me? Like,
100%.
Everybody's on some, like, position clout shit. And like,
so we don't got no ego. We want to see you win. If I feel like you a hard worker, I want to see you win. You the hardest worker other than my manager, Matt Allen, for real. But you the hardest worker for real. I done seen, like, you post every day consistency. That's what I like to see. Like, that shit made me want to go harder. You know what I'm saying? Like,
you did leave me on scene one time.
What the hell? Break it down.
Don't lie. I'm fucking with you. That's good. All right, we got the song ready?
Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah, let's run this shit up. Hey, wait, hold on. Temperature check. So far, we having a good time tonight?
Fuck no, this hell shit lame. This shit boring as hell. Nah, I'm just playing.
Nah, we lit.
Shout out to Lee Podcast, man.
I'm over here drunk as hell. Look at that whole bottle.
Hey, I'm in podcast mode. Fuck is you talking about? Y'all bored.
Hey, where the alcohol at, though, man?
On fire, though.
We need some alcohol. Good night, that
shot. What the hell?
We did it tonight. Check this out.
Run this shit up, JR. Run this shit up.
I'm out.
DT Productions.
I don't got time, I need some more money, ayy. I'm 4PF, I got all my pockets stunky, ayy. That's a fast stack of dubs, you ain't got a honey. Dancing on that bitch when she leave, I'm breaking in the night. Ice get packed, ain't fast, I need a red eye. Split on the kid, now he a dead guy. Back it if I up it, I shoot it, I ain't gon' hold fire. My dog a one through y'all D, hit the whole night. You ain't carry no stick, I told him hold mine. Hold mine. You ain't serving no sour, we on 4-5. We gon' aim at the driver, then hit the co-pilot. Rapper, hell nah, I don't promote violence. Yeah, we ain't the ones dying. I could put a wig on a pig and get the hoe. Bring your plug around, find it my style. I'm alone with the hoe and hit the road, she got low mileage. I don't gotta send a hoe, cause she don't have a wallet. I don't even wanna rap, that's all you rappers lying. Tapped out, body slamming, tapped out. I don't got a red shit, I'm in a trap out. I don't got time, I need me some more money, ayy. I'm 4PF, I got all my pockets chunky, ayy. That's a fat stack of dubs, you ain't got a honey. Dancing on that bitch when she leave, I'm breaking in the night. My ice get back, ain't fast, I need a red eye. Split on the kid, now he a dead guy. Back it, if I up it, I shoot it, I ain't gon' hold fire. My dog a one through y'all team, hit the whole night. You ain't carry no stick, I told him hold mine. You ain't slippin' no sour, hit the front five. I ain't make the driver, they hit the coke. I'm a pippin' ass rapper, hell no, I don't want violence.
Hey, this that dude, F-Trippin', about to drop soon.
They are.
Hey, listen,
The juice in the motherfucking building, JR. Run that shit out real quick before we run this shit out. Whoa.
The boat's trippin' on, we spinning on that cop block. Folks, when it pulled up, bangin' in the drop top. Heard him say he beat a nigga like a piata. From you ain't folks, you time for. The boat's trippin' on, we spinning on that cop block. Folks, when it pulled up, bangin' in the drop top. Heard him say he beat a nigga like a piata. From you ain't folks, you time for.
Pull up, get flipped, that's your bitch, I'm a goon. 104 on the set, I ain't gon' spoon. With the heater, bitch, I'm cooling. They ain't outside. Who the fuck do you think they fooling? Try to run up and I'ma put you on a shirt. Get some issue in your hood and I don't even push no work. If I'm talking sliding, then the homies gonna listen. Bitch, I'm active, even mama know I'm tripping.
The folks tripping on, we spinning on the hot block. Folks, when it pulled up, banging in the drop top. Heard him say he beat a nigga like a piñata. Where I'm from, you ain't folks, and you top five. The folks tripping on, we spinning on the hot block. Folks, when it pulled up, banging in the drop top. Heard him say he beat a nigga like a piñata. Where I'm from, you ain't folks, and you top five.
All my killers come correct, all your killers on the neck. Wow, we're from about them bodies, but he ain't even got a tent. We can't do attempt to hide, my folks is shooting at they man. And we don't be shooting, I was my youngest sliding about to shit. Niggas hiding in they set, kill, die for that set. No, my niggas ain't no killers, but we die by respect. Fucking Instagram, beat my niggas outside with a tech. I be on Westman McDonald's eating fries in the set.
Let's go. Let's go. Are we turning this motherfucker up, man? You was telling this motherfucker killing, you did.
I ain't clear the stage, I'm about to set it off. I feel like Queen Latifah, exotic bros ain't showing no craze. Ain't tryna do no feature, got money now. Tell them suck a dick, I did that shit with Elder. Bust down, bro, my rich, that bitch 100,000 ain't hit the pot. I got it off the thought, you would probably think I'm lying. I just pulled a rock inside a soda pot. Thank God this Tesla driving, but that hoe, I'm right back on that bitch just like her daddy is. Call my safe, off our shoes, I'm fresher than a mannequin. That's that AMG. That 223. Damn, that my jewelry, bend on on they head. Like, who stopped me on that BBL, but I got that bitch some tits. I ain't really tripping, that ain't really tricking, I got it off a bitch. So bitch, I don't really pimp, can't be around not none of you rappers, cause I ain't in a snitch. My razor 22, guns are 22, I'm squeezing till it's clean. But anyways, I'm right back on that bitch, just like her daddy is. I'll break a bitch for everything, don't ask me if we having it, we having it. He said my name, we handled that, 100,000 stuffed up in the mattress, just no cap on
me.
Gang, clear the stage, I'm about to set it off. I feel like Queen Latifah, exotic bros ain't shooting no craze. Ain't trying to do no feature, got money now. Tell them suck a dick, I did that shit with Elder. Bust down, bro, my wrist, that bitch 100,000 ain't hit the pot. I got it off a thought, you would probably think I'm lying. I just pulled a walk inside a soda pot. Thank God this Tesla driving, but that hoe, I'm right back on that bitch just like her daddy is. Call my shades, off my shoes, I'm fresher than a mannequin. That's that AMG. That 223.
And that's on fire, though.
That my jewelry. Back door on their head. Like, who stopped me?
Back door on their head.
Like, who stopped me? Hey,
so look, you heard that song right there? Sexy Red stole my shit. Fuck you talking about?
Oh, that was the Sexy Red shit?
Sexy Red stole my shit, bro.
Jared, what's up? What are you thinking over there, brother?
Sexy Red stole my shit.
Shit, that again, like, I don't know. They music is
it's
like
the same
versatile
producer.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
I dropped before.
I was gonna say that producer kind of sounds familiar.
Gangland.
Did you get that off YouTube or did you
Hell
contact
nah.
the producer himself?
Twin. Nah, I'm trying.
Talk about that. How you know about this?
Nah, but Sexy Red stole that shit. I don't want to get into it. Fuck that. Sexy Red stole that shit. Fuck that shit. On God in heaven, bro. I don't care what nobody say. I'm standing on that shit on fire, though. Sexy Red stole my shit. We had the same producer. The producer sent her the song. She said she liked it. She heard it in the studio on fire, though. I know everything. I know the whole drop.
Hold on.
I know everything.
Hold on.
I don't
want
to show the DMs.
Pause.
I got to do that on Diamond Doe Show.
Pause. In situations like that, what did you do? Like,
nah,
you
shout just, out Sexy Red. She the GOAT. She hard.
So you didn't like, you didn't just ask, like, does she know you like she took it from you?
I got DMs, bro.
No, that's what I'm saying. Like, does she know that she got it from you?
Bro.
Or like she have no clue about it?
I got DMs. Tell her, bro.
Yeah, you need a mic.
So, bro, where your mic at, bro?
Yeah, she know. You know what I mean? She know what it is.
She wouldn't, you know, like, just, y'all couldn't just do it as one song?
That would have been hard, but come on, man. You think she gonna do that?
she was fucking with the producer. He was showing her a couple of songs that he did, and he showed her my shit, and then she's like, let me get a beat like this, and he gave her a beat like this. And he told me the whole story, and she took the fucking whole shit, bro.
So, well, that song already out, though.
Huh?
Okay, hey, wait. Based upon this interview today, I have to ask this question. Is this the controversy clout reach, or is this something that actually happened?
You tell me, bro. What you
No, you tell me.
You tell me. I'm the one telling you. I told you what the situation. What do you feel? How you feel about it?
For me, it's like, unless there's like you actually talk to Sexy Red, this is just like a controversy thing.
I told you I had DMs.
Yes. Can we see it?
Like, I'm doing that. You can see a person. You can see a
person.
Hell no, I can't even do that. Maybe after the podcast. Maybe after the podcast.
Ooh.
Hey, but shout out to Sexy Red, though. She stole my shit. Fuck.
Hey,
fire,
hey,
though.
Cause this is the
I
thing.
I don't know what they talking about.
This is the thing.
Hey, shout out to Diamond Doe Show on there. I'm gonna show everything. We're gonna have a whole episode about that motherfucker.
Shit. Because
and you're gonna be there. I'm gonna make sure.
Yeah, that's cool. But you can scream it, but you gotta actually prove it.
I don't gotta prove it. They know. Look at the comments. Go on, Juice and Lock. Shout out Juice and Lock. Go look at the comments. They riding with me. Fuck that. She stole my shit. I do gotta prove it. I proved it. I said it. That's me proving it. And
you never showed the DMs.
When I expose the truth,
you
it's
never showed
hurt.
The DMs.
It's
though.
Gonna hurt.
But you know, but like,
fam, I'm holding a Thanos ring and like in my hand. Like, you don't understand. Like, I give you the
so
Thanos
why the
ring.
Fuck, you ain't letting it go.
You're
like Mr. Controversy. You say you with the shit. So why are you holding ring. The ring? Like, get the shit off.
I'm gonna it be like
the rollout.
Yeah, I'm gonna fuck their head up.
I think the
y'all don't gotta believe me, bro. You don't gotta believe me.
No, I say I didn't, but I think the reason why he's holding the stuff in there is the same reason why you hold the stuff in there.
On God in heaven.
The difference is, I said I'm protecting my peace. He said I'm with all the bullshit.
That is true.
There's a difference.
That is true.
He's lying, though. He with the bullshit, too.
A little bit.
Nah. He stole my shit.
I bet.
She stole my shit.
She stole my shit. That shit.
Let it be known.
But shout out Sexy Red, though.
Shout out Sexy Red, though.
Bitch stole my shit, bro.
Bow.
Hey, you
I'm fucking with that
you
shit.
You would still do a song with her and all that.
Oh, let go. Come on. I'm not even a hater. I'm just saying. I'm not mad.
Yeah.
I'm just saying. What happened?
Yeah.
I'm not mad.
He's honored.
I'm honored.
Yeah.
Shout out to Sexy Red. I like it.
Booty beat.
But I'm off.
Booty beat.
No, Diddy.
Booty me.
No, Diddy. No.
That's the deepest shit, though. Deepest shit, though, ever
since. They said in the chat, your song is better, Don't Chip. Dirty Feet took your song.
Dirty Feet.
Dirty Feet.
What?
Calling it Dirty Feet is crazy.
That's fucked up.
She be going on stage with it barefoot.
That's it.
Oh, I like Sexy Red.
Huh?
I like Sexy
Red. Like a nigger.
I like Sexy Red. Fuck it.
Type B type shit. I bet.
Would you smack her?
Hey,
nah.
Hey, who's Sexy Red?
I sent her though.
Hey, wait, hold on. Sexy Red or Suki?
Neither.
I don't know.
If you have to pick one.
I don't like. They're not my type.
At all.
What's your type?
What's your type?
We did this last time. And I had everybody mad at me for this question right here. I had everybody mad at me for this question.
So let's repeat it.
Let's not repeat this one.
I wasn't there. I wasn't there.
Sending with the bullshit and you lied.
Let's go.
I wasn't there.
You lied.
I wasn't there. So
I'm right here. I ain't turning nothing down.
What's your type?
I like all the flavors. Everything. Like, you know how you go to the soda machine, you pour all the soda. You know how you go to the soda machine?
But it's always that one flavor you just don't put in there though. And that's
I like my stomp down, my bottom bitch for real. You know? Shout out her.
Shout out
I don't
your
wanna
bottom
say
bitch is crazy. Shouting out your bottom bitch is crazy.
Nah, how that crazy? Shout out my stomp down for real. She respectable. She be in
yeah,
the field.
But yeah, I'm not saying she's not respectable.
She be in the field.
But for you to say shout out my bottom
that's
bitch.
That's a compliment. Tell your homie that's a compliment.
Crazy.
Though. Right?
It's levels to this shit.
Got a mic, twin. You ain't got the mic.
Hey,
what's a bottom bitch? Bottom bitch like yo.
Bottom bitch is what? Explain it. Break it down.
That's like yo. That's like yo. You know?
No, I don't know. Huh?
It's like yo.
I ain't no kid.
That's like you know.
I'm not a pimp either. I don't know. I'm a yimp. But
that.
what I'm saying.
But you know, what I'm asking is, what is a bottom bitch like?
What a game.
It's like just a bitch that holds you down. Just like do everything, do the work.
Say that.
Make sure everything good.
Yeah. From the outside, it sounds crazy. From the inside, they know what you're talking about. I don't.
That's what it is, though. It's like solid. She's solid.
Yeah.
Solid. Y'all speaking in Chinese again?
Never mind. JR, don't say never mind, bro. Never minds are not allowed.
Like a bottom bitch, is that like, is that's like the whole, like the wifey's? That's the one that's like the main one? That's the one like you
wifey's
have kids
like a,
with?
Like a, wifey's like a...
Yeah, you got to explain
a broad name, like,
well,
not wifey.
Usually
a little
bottom
context.
The bottom bitch like
podcast,
the family
you got
to
explain it for
bottom break, bitch like my life.
Break it down.
Stomp down.
Nah. Say it, though.
He stops because he's stopping different.
Yes or no?
It's the breadwinner.
That's the one. That's like the one that hold it down. That's the one that hold it down.
That's the one bring... That's the reason he has diamonds on his neck.
Like the one that just do a part. You feel what I'm saying or not?
Yeah, I do. But like outside, it's kind of dangerous.
I don't know what. I'm protected.
Hey,
I'm a protective person.
If you ain't taking risks for it, man,
I'm a protective person.
Yeah, you know I mean,
I'm telling you that right now. We take risks though. We got to. But I don't know. I don't do that. None of that.
I'm trying to figure out what that we going back to. Really,
I don't know
like,
nothing.
What was the whole like you said the bottom one? So I'm trying to figure out what.
Yeah, that's just a girl that'll hold it down for you.
Yeah.
Okay.
She's just not. She never
she's
going.
The foundation.
She ain't
Where's
leaving.
The foundation
she ain't leaving. She ain't going nowhere. She gonna stick around no matter what. You can only get one bottom bitch.
Oh.
Yo, bottom bitch
she's
only
the foundation.
One.
Okay.
That's your life.
Yes, sir.
See, that's where it get tricky because you say you only can get one.
You can only have one. That's your rock. That's your foundation. She calling me right now on a no caller ID. Swear to God, right now as we speak, she probably mad at me. But
how you know it's no? How you know it's her?
Huh?
How you know it's her?
Cause it's regular.
Mr. Controversy.
It's regular, Pippen.
It's being real political right now.
It's regular, Pippen.
Oh, the bottom bitch is calling. Oh shit! She said, "Fuck her ID."
Answer that.
Oh shit!
Answer that.
Answer that.
Hey, y'all the League Podcast, who we talking to? The bottom bitch.
Hey, yo, it's the one and only Macaroni. All right, look, let me help the homie out. Let me help the homie out real quick.
Hold on, we can't hear you. Hey, we can't hear you. Hold on, we can't hear you. Hey, what did you say? Go ahead, bro.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, we can hear you.
All right, so check it out, man. The bottom bitch is really the top bitch, right?
That's what I'm trying to say.
That's the top bitch. He couldn't get it out of there. But I tell you what, that was respect is what he was trying to say, but it came off disrespect because y'all talking about sexy red, dirty feet and shit. Y'all already confused. Check it out. Nah, I'm fucking with you. But
look, that was a good one. That was a good one.
No, it's clarity. We need clarity.
You're on point.
We needed clarity. So far, so good. Let's check it out. Go ahead.
That part. And then another thing, I don't think sexy red stole your song. I think the producer gave her your song, and she just ran with it. But I tell you what,
that's what I'm saying. What do you call that? What do you call it?
Huh?
That's called stealing.
Yo,
what do you call it?
Is crazy.
Nah, that's the song. That's called.
That's
that 4X trading shit. Hey, nah, but Lito, man, bring the dancers back. You know what I'm talking about?
Bring the dancers back.
Not all of them. He got everybody. Hey, look, we had a couple bullet heads in there last time. Bitches with bullet holes and holes in their vans and
with
shit.
Bullet
but I tell
holes?
You what, I tell you what, we gonna get it right, bro. We gonna get some real exquisite type of bitches in there, so then you can know what a top bitch, a bottom bitch, a middle bitch, any bitch. That, but anyway, man, yeah, Swag OD, but get it right. Hey, Donald.
Yeah.
Wait.
We are Izzo tonight.
Who, you know him on the phone?
Yeah.
Who's this?
That the macaroni.
No phone.
Swag OD.
Oh, Swag. Yeah, Swag. Oh, okay. Cool. All right, cool. I just
the
wanted
one and
to,
only.
Yeah, I wanted to make sure we knew who we were talking to. All right, bet.
I was about to cook.
You can have a whole podcast.
I was about to cook.
Phone.
All right, bet. Cool. Thank
you. Go ahead and cook. Go ahead and cook. Just know that it's real chicken grease and shit popping over here. You dig?
Yeah.
That part.
Nah, I'm fuck with y'all though, man. I'll go up, man. I'll tell you what. OC 11. I'm in the bathroom talking to y'all. Goddamn, I gotta go all that through again.
And we pulling up. We pulling up.
He said, what's up?
And if y'all
grease.
Can't make it, man, hey, Boozy Lounge, March 30th, Huntington Beach. After
yeah,
hours,
let go. The homie shit. We throwing it.
That part, 100.
Yeah, my dad. Like, the homies coming here and drop bombs. They've been listening. They've been listening.
Fighting said,
damn.
Oh!
Wow. 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 They slapped his foot like.
Wow.
I bet. All right, hey, what's up? What's next? What are we doing?
What's up? What's
up? What's up? What's up? What's all right, word? So real quick.
This is the drunkest I ever been on a podcast. Where did my mother home fire, though?
I've been drunk. I've been drunk as a bitch on a podcast.
You've been way drunker than me. I got it here.
Hey, JR. Why does everybody come on here and tell us what weed and alcohol does to them? That's what I
hey,
want to
man,
know.
That,
every
that
episode.
Shit, that shit
Cam,
is crazy.
Cam, I
every,
need you to make a list.
Every
why,
episode,
what
bro.
Wrong with it?
Every
nothing's
episode.
Wrong with it, but it's like a transition word that's comfortable. When people come on here. No, I'm not saying it's a bad thing.
It's like use another excuse. It's
yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah. I'm not saying it's a bad thing.
What the hell?
No,
yeah,
no, no,
it was
no,
like,
no.
I was being for real.
I'm not saying that you're not. I'm not saying that you're not.
I was really saying, like, this is I didn't say, oh, I'm so drunk right now. Like, how you guys doing?
No,
I said,
no.
I said, this is the drunkest
that's
I've ever been on
said.
A podcast.
That is what you said.
Bro, don't try to do me like I was like, I'm just so high right now. I can't even talk. How are you guys? How you guys feeling?
Okay.
I said,
you did
hey, bro,
good.
I'm the drunkest I've ever been on a podcast.
Hey, no, but let me tell you this. There's a lot of people that come in this couch. And you guys are different because you guys are podcasters. You're active. You talk. You feel me? So you're like on it and shit like that. But when people come on this couch and they don't have enough like.
Is that us? Is that what JR was trying
no,
to
no,
say?
No.
I feel like you was calling us out
a
little bit.
It's just like a thing. Like everybody comes to the room and if I have people come in the room and don't do no weed, don't smoke none, and they blame still the alcohol and the weed. Like.
Oh,
but they not
smoking.
They
didn't
even
hit
so
the
blunt. So it's like, it's just a normal
time. The room is so smoky.
Get over it.
It's always weed.
You can't say we not high. You can't say we not high right now.
No, you can be high, but you're not going to be like, oh, my God, I don't know what's going on. This ain't peak cocaine. It's smoke.
I might do that. I might do that with my bitch. I'll be doing that with my bitch.
I can't even see the colors in here. Hey, yo, you ever had anybody act fake lit?
Oh,
one
yeah.
time, one time, right, this girl,
no,
one, time, one yeah. time, this girl act fake drunk, and I'm like, hey, this I knew she was faking it because I didn't see her like drink anything at all. So like, instead of like, she was looking for like a hand, like, oh my god, I'm drunk, and like wanted me to save her. Hey, I was like, bitch, flop. Prove how drunk you are. That shit is crazy. You ever seen anybody fake their litness?
I don't know. I don't even know.
I see some weird shit, man.
I don't even know that they faking it.
You don't pay attention. They around you. Hey, open your eyes, buddy. No, around you. You just came off tour. A bitch stole his phone.
Oh!
Hey.
My phone, though.
Hey, if you're on the team player position, keep your eyes open to these drunk bitches.
Hey,
we
found
the phone. Weird shit like that be happening all the time too.
He said, "I'll be paying attention to these bitches. Anytime a random bitch comes in this room, his eyes are open. His eyes are open, and my eyes are wide open."
I'll be paying attention to the bullshit. Though. He's telling us to tighten up. We be tightened up though,
huh?
We be tightened up. We'll be worrying about that. Most of the time.
Yeah, most of the time.
We don't worry about the bitches because the bitches, they don't be playing that shit. That's why I thought
feel
it was
like
so crazy.
You could tell who,
I guess when.
You could tell who's a weirdo and who's not. Now, I mean, you could tell peep the energy type
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, but anytime there's new around you, like, it's
oh,
not
yeah,
like,
sure,
like it's one thing to have girls around you and, like, yeah, pussy's pussy. But, like, fuck pussy. I got eyes wide open because I see some grimy-ass shit. Anybody that's around me in this room, I'm in a corner for a reason.
We called the hoes out. Regardless. We called them out. Regardless. We pressed the issue.
Yeah, we understand what you did, but you just said, I don't keep my eyes on them.
No, I ain't never said
that. Hey, you got
to. I ain't said that one.
Nah, what did you say?
I don't know. Oh. I don't know what I said.
The cook-up is crazy.
I don't know what I said.
Don't matter no more. It's recorded and documented. Go back. You'll see it tomorrow.
Rewind it.
Hey,
we got the play up.
I ain't worried about no bitch, but when we outside, we really on 10, though. You feel me?
I get off on anything. I ain't worried about nothing. That shit. Oh, God, 20, five, though. We from Anaheim, California, G-O-D.
You can tell, and if they J-Cash, they weirdos.
And we still,
I mean,
we press every
issue.
Hey,
that's the question I got.
Nothing
not,
to say, no
not,
shit
they ain't around us.
This is a genuine
shit.
Question, because I see that word going around a lot. I need the actual definition. What the fuck is a J-Cap?
J-Cap.
Like a lame, a goofy, like don't be around here. Like, so you a J-Cap.
But what?
Like, we'll roll you out.
So, like, J-Cap's like a, like,
somebody,
a goofy? Like,
somebody that ain't there, all there in their head. Yeah, you know I mean? Yeah, like a weirdo type stupid. Shit. Like who
somebody
fuck?
Off.
Somebody
yeah.
smoke
like,
the fuck
usually,
out the game.
Usually like
shit,
a tweaker,
you know
though.
Mean?
Like, you tweaking. Like, you a J-Cap.
You don't even got to be a tweaker to be a J-Cap. You know
nah,
mean?
But like
just
most of the
time, like, damn, bro. Like who?
Like an airhead, basically.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, I seem to be thrown around. Like, when people talk shit to each other, they're like, J-Cap this, J-Cap that. But I don't know the definition of it. So, like, I'm just on the outside trying to listen.
You don't want to be caught. That's probably the most offensive word.
Yeah, you don't want to be a J-Cat.
If you in jail or prison, you—that's the most offensive word. You gotta get off.
You ain't no J-Cats were in the on the yard. You know what I mean, they on the other.
Yeah, but people were out here, not even back there, and they're trying to put that label on people out here.
Shit. I don't know nobody's situation. I just know if you call somebody that, you better be ready to fight or die about it. But
I
it depends
agree.
On how you say it. I be messing around with the homies all the time. I'll be like saying some shit. You feel me? But
that's crazy. Yeah.
But
well,
it depends on your demeanor, though, right?
I did my homework today. I figured a new. I, like that's really been on my mind. Like, cause I'm like, I see people calling it, but I feel like that term came up with like in this last year that it came popular.
Yeah.
You feel me? It's been around for a while, but like that it came popular to the internet. I just started recently seeing that shit. Me. Yeah. Type shit.
What's the worst word to call somebody other than a bitch?
Take it.
Mark is such an old way of dissing.
Yeah,
somebody.
But for me, weird, like, I, like me,
it's old.
Like me personally, I don't really take offense to words because I feel like when anybody's hurt, they'll say anything to try to hurt you. So whatever you're telling me, that shit don't really mean shit to me.
Yeah,
like you feel me? Call me whatever you want. I don't fucking care. Yeah. Like really. Like when I'm popping, I'm a target. You're gonna put anything on me. You feel me? Like type shit. That's what it is.
Nah,
if you got an op out there, they're going to call you a J-Cat and all that other shit because they just trying to make you look bad. You feel me? That doesn't mean that you are that.
Yeah.
But they're going to try to use anything in the book to try to, like,
I got them people
downplay the name. You feel me?
You better than me, bro. Straight up.
You better than me, too.
The words.
That's what I was
going
to say. To each his own.
You know what I mean? Like, that shit. Really
words mean something, though.
No, I understand
but
that.
But, like, I could be on a podcast and, like, you know, be bullshitting with you all the time.
About,
but it's just a certain
it ain't
line,
about
right?
The
like,
word, it's about respect. You know what I mean? Like, when somebody crossed the line, ain't no going back to that.
Just
like,
talking
you
about
I mean?
Direct name calling is like disrespectful.
Yeah,
no
yeah, but
what.
but for me, this is what I'm saying. Like, I understand that there's levels to this, right?
Yeah.
And so, like, entertaining the bullshit, it goes back to that, right? Like, if it's bullshit, there's levels to this shit. And so, you guys, like, the shit that you guys entertain, how much are you willing to entertain is the question.
Nah, we don't
right?
ever do no disrespectful shit.
No. You're not looking for it, but if it comes to
I'll
you
fuck around and argue on this podcast all night with you,
yeah,
but
yeah,
I'll never call you out your name. You know what I'm saying?
No,
like,
yeah, yeah, type shit. But yeah,
you
yeah,
feel
but,
me?
Yeah,
it's
yeah,
just,
but what I'm saying is, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about what he's talking about. The respect level and, like, I'm a better
person. That's
a
line of respect,
and,
right?
Like, the shit that he wouldn't let slide and I would let slide because. Where you live in two totally different worlds, you feel me?
And
so in my thing, like, I just see everything out there as, like, trolling me. I see it all as, like, trolling. Like, they can't access me. And so if I show them any, like, access or I show them that they're getting to me, then it's like I show them that they won. You feel me? Me. Because I'm in a different position. You're in the streets with them. And so these people that are calling that out, it's a different type of thing going on over there. So I understand why you have to address it.
And not everything needs to be physical either, but it's
see,
like addressing back, though, right? Like,
yeah.
Say
see,
someone say
I don't
something
address
like,
shit on the internet, though. I mean, because unless I see you in real life, I ain't worried about you. You feel me? All that internet shit is like, that's cool. Whatever. Pop that shit. Say whatever the fuck you want to say on the internet. You feel
every
me?
Day.
But in real life, man. I mean, you got to watch what you say in real life to somebody's fresh. Face because that's when it's going to get real. You feel me? Like,
yeah,
that's
all
fake.
That internet shit. That's cool. You feel me? I'll see you when I see you. But like,
that don't matter.
Face
though.
To face. Oh, yeah. You're not going to say that.
Yeah.
Say that. Got to respect it. All right. Bet. Hey, the internet. We ready to wrap it up? Hey, JR. The internet.
What's up,
wrap
man?
It up. Go ahead, pause. No Diddy.
No Diddy.
Whoa.
No Diddy. No Diddy.
Wrap it up.
Diddy. No Diddy, man. First and foremost, shout out to Domino. Appreciate y'all coming, man.
Shout
fuck
to
with
y'all
podcast. That. Fuck with the whole collab. Y'all coming over here. You know what I'm saying? It's a good little movement. I can't wait to go back over there.
Hell yeah, we're going.
Over there, that was the first time they had the whole like dude doing the audio shit. Everything lined up. That was like an eye opener to us. You know what I'm saying?
We still ain't got that,
but shit, we moving. We've been breaking mountains, but hey, I appreciate y'all coming.
You know what I'm saying?
Shout out to y'all, podcast. Man. Hey, 2024, man, we shaking shit, you know what I'm saying?
Let's go.
We're moving shit, going crazy. JR's on the road. Like I said, this weekend we in Vegas. Anybody out of Vegas or trying to go to Vegas, going to be turned the fuck up. It's going to be lit, man. Like I said, stay tapped in, for real.
Say that. I bet. Hey, Doe, what's up? Dear Internet, face that camera. Say your last goodbye to everybody watching. Bro.
What camera? This camera right here?
This camera right here, straight ahead.
Hey, man, one time, man. Shout out to Leak Podcast for having us and all that. Man, we appreciate y'all. We for sure going to be back to fuck with y'all. Y'all got to come fuck with us and all that. Hey, but one time, Don. It's the Diamond Doe Show, man. Yeah, man, we lit.
Say that.
Hey, we back, man. We coming back season two and all that shit, man. Be
20
stay ready.
Episodes.
Y'all mean?
Fuck around, you talking about?
I'm excited for that.
We coming. I'm excited for all that shit. Let's go ahead, Dom. What up?
Yo, Dom the Kid, man. 51 Mafia. Shout out my brothers, Raps, Matt Allen, Snotty, Doe in this motherfucker, Hundo in this motherfucker, everybody, man. You know what I'm saying? That's it, bro. We just came up here trying to promote what we doing. You know what I'm saying? Fuck with my boy and all that. You know what it is? 51 Mafia. I'm
big shit popping, little shit stopping. Fuck going on. I'm drunk as hell.
I can talk all night, man. 51 Mafia.
You want to say the internet?
And we got the juice, bitch.
Hey, my brother don't even talk like that. He be right here just posted. You feel me?
Yeah, that part.
That's my dog. That's my twin.
I bet. Hey, Bands, what's up?
Bands going to Vegas?
Yeah, hey, I'm going to Vegas this weekend. Matter of fact, I wasn't going out there Saturday, but it turns out I will be out there Friday. Got to talk.
They are.
Yeah, but Friday, but we outside. Vegas going stupid. You feel me? Big J going crazy.
Hey, tell everybody about the tour drive. April 7th.
You feel me? To all y'all that gained some weight that can't fit y'all clothes no more. It's a lot of y'all motherfuckers. Hit the gym too. But I need them clothes. So we giving them back to the homeless. You feel me? I got the food cracking. And we going to be outside. You feel me? Having fun, giving back. Do some stuff other than club. You feel me?
April 7th, what time?
1 o'clock. You feel me? The address is on my page. You feel me? At the meet-up spot. And then we going to pull up.
Where you guys going to Skid Row or something like that?
Yeah, Skid Row. Where all the homeless is at.
I bet. Say that. Yeah, if you guys got any clothes, water, food, anything you guys want to donate, contact anybody in this podcast. We're going to go on April 7th to give back to the community. If you guys want to join us, feel free to pull up and do that with us. If not, you know what I mean? Just meet up with us prior to that and give us a shit, and we'll go out there and do the work and all that shit or whatever. But it's cold out there, and it's time to give back. You feel me? For us and shit like that. So that's where we're at. Say that. April 7th, 1 o'clock.
Oh, yeah. Chase, all banks tapping. We going crazy.
This nigga spreading the word. Crazy. All right. You got a song to exit with us? You got an exit song?
Yeah. Of course I do.
All right, bet. All right, let me just end it real quick. Hold on. Let me get my camera right.
Yeah, Sersky.
All right. Oh, hold on. Hey, until next time, it's the Leak Podcast. Thank you for spending your time with us tonight. You could have been anywhere in the world, but you're here with us. We appreciate that shit. Dom and Doe, listen.
Yeah.
It's at, like for me, bro, I really, 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 where I'm at in life, I needed to change my frequency. And having you guys here was a good little, like, frequency change, and the vibes were up. Thank you.
Hell yeah. Thank you. Know that, brother.
Thank you, bro. Like, real me, that's me talking real shit.
Hell yeah,
you feel
I appreciate
me?
It. Yeah,
on God in heaven. That, like, though, last time you weren't here, the fact that you're here for me, that means a lot. You feel me?
He don't pop out nowhere.
No,
this is about a bag. I swear to God.
Yeah. But I just need to verbalize that shit. You feel me? Because it's big shit, bro. Having you here in the room, your time is precious. I understand.
I appreciate that.
Yeah, no, for real. Time is valuable, bro. You feel me? People lose that shit, and you're here with us. So definitely appreciate your time.
Appreciate you having me, man.
All right, bet. Until next time, it's the Leak Podcast. Tune in, tap in. Mondays, Wednesdays, all that shit. You'll see us at their show. You'll see us at our show. You all know. That good shit.
Yeah, that part.
Hey, if it's up, it's up. And it's just stuck.
You did. And
bring that
stinky.
Shit,
J.R.
Yeah,
thanks, right, brother.
Slide my Rolls Royce through the hood. That shit look good, like right on. Get your arms and learn your hair done when you want from now on. Tell the police I don't do nothing. I've been selling these songs. Ain't put no cap inside my rap. Ain't too much leading your own. My little youngin' really sly. He lives in shite all day. Everybody in the supercharge. I know we getting away. She want me to come inside of who? I'm nutter than her face. I don't like to go too many places. I run shit in LA. Get a hotel for a year straight. Ain't no pull-up where I stay. I know bitches who set niggas up. Yeah. I know niggas who let bitches too. Yeah. I've been in 100 million moves. Life is real. Let her pop a pill. She enjoyed herself. Bad bitch. Put them in the arena. And go below the belt. No referee. Ain't no stopping me. I'm trying to take it down. The only problems I'm having in life was watching them well. I grew up on that take shit. I don't know how to steal. I ain't with all that fake shit. I'd rather keep it real. You mad at me about a bitch. Who fucking both of us? I went and ran my money up. I swear it's over for them. I done gave my feelings up. I don't know who to trust. She coming up missing at the spot. I don't know who to bust. She my gangsta bitch. I gave her racks and told her stash that. Love it when you throw it back like, damn, you know that ass fat. You know I'm a blast back. You know I'm way past that. So why you acting like it's something that it wasn't? She know how to make me mad. I swear this bitch put Jerry button. I know how to run up cash. I swear I'm getting hella money. Real spill. Slide my Rolls Royce through the hood. That shit look good like right on. Get your own salon. Your hair done when you want from now on. Tell the police I don't do nothing. I've been selling these songs. Ain't put no cap inside my rap. Ain't too much being your own. Slide my Rolls Royce through the hood. That shit look good like right on. Your arms and learn your hair done when you want from now on. Tell the police I don't do nothing. I've been selling these songs. Ain't put no cap inside my rap. Ain't too much leading your own. They don't put me on your camera. You know what I look like. She like put it in me raw. I ask her what I look like. They just call me when you get here. You know I don't book flights. We can't pop out. It won't even look right. I just hit the woman of my dreams with another bitch. I just scratched 10 million off my bucket list. I'm never on no sucker shit. I see the stand behind me. I swear I love this shit. Building up for my kids, kids, kids. I ain't gon' never quit. Fill the band over with bass, get a little bro, them a job. You can come get rich with us, you gon' eat or you gon' stop. Keep it certified, hit a sin, I pay them not to rob. Pop out 2020 color, and I'm riding in a spot. Those people hate and I'm on top, I bulletproof the car. All the members made free bands, I pack, look like they crackin' cards. Juno for a fact, I keep it real, still ain't tatered. Still ain't tatered.
They are.